Calhoun, the junior out of Riverside, California, with 4-5 speed, loose football. But it was covered by, it was recovered by San Jose State. So the Spartans capitalize early. Let's see who gets up off the bottom of the pile. Larry Weldon, number one, a junior out of San Jose, the man that got that loose football.
We can see a little lead draw here. Quarterback backs up like pass, and 26 leads the play up inside. 74 first man on the play, and a great job of filling through. Who made the recovery?
Jim? It was recovered by Larry Weldon, and the fumble was forced by Mark Dean, a junior out of San Jose. First and 10, here come the Spartans again. Cracking over the left side with number 32, Mike Meredith out of Belmont, California. Junior college transfer out of San Mateo College. Averaged over 7 yards per carry last year for San Jose State.
Great hit by Ted Hinton, number 84. Certainly blasted through, got good penetration. And thus far, the defenses certainly have been the dominant factor in this game.
Second down and a long 10 for the Spartans. Motion across by Meredith. Back pedaling. Goes Carlson. In and out of the hands of his intended receiver, Lafo Malalulu, the junior out of Oceanside. Watch the coverage now by number 44, the free safety, Tom Phillips, the sophomore out of Redlands, California.
They ran motion, just got everyone locked on a man, and everyone playing fairly tight across. As he broke the out route, there really was a catchable ball, and it just slipped through the fingers. Certainly, Malo's not going to do too many like that.
Coming out wide to the left side, Cortez Thomas, third and 10. Back goes Carlson, man open, and it is intercepted. Tom Phillips, who was back on the coverage on the preceding play, came up with the INT intended for Lafu Malalulu, but the ball was badly underthrown.
Here's one that should never have been thrown. Phillips is sitting in the middle just waiting for the ball. You can see the deep drop right at the top of the screen by Phillips. Now he's just sitting waiting for the ball, playing the quarterback's eyes. Now he breaks the pass, and it's an interception all the way. In fact, Phillips was sitting there waiting. I thought he would probably make a good return because he was in such excellent position.
The interception by that man, Tom Phillips, they told us he reads defenses very well.
Out for the best things in life. And Mercury is reaching farther, too. You can see it in the sophisticated shape of the new Mercury Sable and all the Mercury cars. They're shaped to use the wind to help them hold the road, no matter how high you climb. Mercury, the shape you want to be in.
Tonight's telecast between Fullerton State and San Jose State is brought to you by Mercury Cars, the shape you want to be in. And by the U.S. Armed Forces. It's a great place to start. 12:04 left to go in a scoreless first quarter. The Spartans of San Jose State. They got the first break. They had a fumble recovery, but then they threw the ball up and the interception by Tom Phillips. So the Titans get the ball back, but it's deep in their own territory, just as good as a punt. First and 10 for Fullerton State, just outside their own 10-yard line. Kevin Jan, the senior quarterback, bends in. Motion across by Lockett, number 17. Pitch back, sweeping the right side. Burness Scott. He's the man with that breakaway speed. 4-5 speed in the 40, they say. Tackled by Casey Clark. How much is speed in the 40-yard dash? Is it overrated as a stat when you evaluate a player?
I think it's overrated. You know, the players that have the great speed aren't always the great football players. And some individuals that run 4-5 run 4-4 in football. Some that run 4-4 run 4-8 in football. So still got to determine how the kid plays.
I like what Bum Phillips, the head coach of the New Orleans Saints, says, especially when he times his defensive lineman. He says, forget the 40-yard speed. I don't even like 20-yard speed. A defensive lineman's 20 yards off the ball, he's in the wrong spot.
That's true.
A dive play on second and 9 to Bo White out of Daly City, California. He averages about 4.6 yards per carry. And the coaches say he has really improved his mental toughness over the last couple of seasons. Jimmy Priest in on the tackle, number 58, the junior out of Stockton, California. Third and seven facing the Fullerton State Titans. Kevin Jan in the passing department. What does he need to work on? He's an intermediate range passer.
Kevin Jan certainly has excellent ability to read the football field, has a very good arm, does not have great quickness.
Blitz is on, unloads, and it is incomplete. Actually, the lineman was closer to the football than the intended receiver. The man that came crashing through right there, number 74, the junior out of San Jose, California, is Mark Dean. He was an excellent high school wrestler, came out of San Jose City College, and it brings up the punting situation on fourth and seven. 10:38, it's a scoreless first quarter here in San Jose. Freddie Payton is back deep, that is he, number 21. A distant relative, we are told.
Got the right bloodlines, though, Jim.
Of Walter Payton. And Jim Suroy, who averages just under 40 yards per punt. Payton at the 45. And is down at the 45. Loose football, but he covers his own fumble. So we played 10:28 here in San Jose, and the Spartans and the Titans deadlock zip to zip.
Forget that artsy guy with the beard. Let Rex direct your script.
Forget it.
Well, come on, let's
get it.
We shape today's Mercury Cougar to help it hold the road. No matter which road you choose. Mercury, the shape you want to be in.
We're not a company, but we'll give you a chance to work where there's always a challenge. We'll give you opportunities to learn, to develop, to perfect skills that you thought were beyond your reach. We'll help you build a career. A career that can reward you for the rest of your life. We're not a company. We're your country. We're the Army, the Navy, the Air Force, the Marines. We're the Armed Forces. It's a great place to start.
You've seen a little chalk talk in your day?
I think right now they're trying to determine a way to get a first down. We haven't yet approached that. Thus far, really, Fullerton has been very conservative. It might have been the field position they had the last time, but they've got to start pulling it out to get the movement of the football going up the field.
Malalulu and Crawford are the wide receivers. Baxter, Meredith, and Tatum. And cracking over the right side goes Mike Meredith. Blocking up front by the unheralded men in the trenches. Number 62 is the center, Don Teague. And over on the right side, Michael Session, the senior right guard out of Houston, Texas. And over on the left side, it is David Diaz Infante. Second down and eight. Quick hurry up offense. Carlson backpedals, looks for the quick out. Man was covered, in trouble, and down he goes at the 39-yard line.
An excellent job by the whole secondary of the Cal State team. They dropped back. They had two half-field safeties, five underneath, and they're sitting right in the middle of it.
Hurry up offense again. You surprised?
Well, I think after that last play, they might as well have slowed it down. It certainly wasn't effective for them.
Third and 15. Big yardage. Man open, and it is caught. Was he inbounds or out of bounds? They give Lapo Malalulu a great catch. Watch him drag the feet.
All three does. Malo is go down, does a great job of dragging. Certainly had the one, and it's all that's required. There's no question it was a legitimate catch and legitimate call.
So Carlson begins to get on track. He ranked 21st in total offense in 1983. There is Gene Murphy, the head coach of Fullerton's Titans.
And this is beginning to look a little more like we might anticipate San Jose looking. A lot of three-step drop, quick pass stuff. Let's hurry up and throw the ball some more. That's what they've been doing to move the football, and they've been a good offensive team thus far.
The book on Carlson so far this evening. First and 10 from the 44, Fullerton State. Sweep to the left is not developed. Loose football, and it's recovered by Mike Meredith, who just dropped the handle. First thing you've got to do is get that loaf of bread.
Would seem as though it's extremely important that you do not leave ball on grass. This is one of those, and now puts them in the hole, and Maybe it's a good thing. It'll force them to go back to the pass, and that's been their thing all along. Last week, they ended up minus yards with the rush, but had a very fine, productive night of passing.
The injured Titan, Bill Bryan, freshman out of Alta Loma, California, and he is the biggest linebacker for Fullerton State, 6'2", 220, and still growing. This is Bryan's little boy, Bill.
They're really high on Bryan, think he's going to be a great player, has that ability just to hit you from a one-foot or a two-foot range, and they think that he will be, before he gets out of Fullerton, one of their finest defensive football players.
9:22, it's still scoreless, the Spartans and the Titans.
Some say he came from a distant planet. Others say he's from Dayton.
Great guy, tough guy.
He brought an army with him.
Tuna.
Here, sir.
Smooth seal.
Yo.
Modahani.
Here, TG.
About pets.
Equipped with a trusty double money back guarantee. They fearlessly fight.
Company.
The enemies of your car.
Shake 'em.
Great guy, tough guy.
The Kingside Army's available at auto departments throughout the universe.
Well done, Toad.
Look for the tough guy. Or use your magic decoder ring.
We're not a company, but we recognize potential. We develop it. We use it. We'll make sure that as your responsibility grows, so will you. As your ability for leadership grows, so will you. Working with us, you'll gain self-confidence. Become a person with a future. We're not a company. We're your country. We're the Marines, the Army, the Navy, the Air Force. We're the Armed Forces. It's a great place to start.
Back live, San Jose State and Fullerton State, nothing with 9:16 and counting. Second down and 20 for the Spartans. Carlson sending a man in motion. That's Cortez Thomas, wide to the top of the screen. A little draw play, late to develop. Mike Meredith, hole left side, cracks it inside the 50 and busts it down to the 47 of Fullerton State before Russ Mayberry, number 99 out of Covina, California, was the first man there in the white jersey to bring him down.
Looks like they're going to go again with the quick huddle offense here, Jim.
Third and 20. Slot formation to the right, deployed wide to the left. Lafo Malalulu, their leading receiver, just a junior, and he's a good one. Carlson looks wide open. Malalulu, and he's off to the races. Loose football, it's recovered by Fullerton State.
I believe he ran out of bounds before he got there. They had a roll corner. The corner bounced him. He ran out of bounds, and the half-field safety was in a way into the middle, so I think that the play will be called back. Excellent hole and back of the roll corner, but he did a good job of bumping Malo.
Watch how wide open he gets. Had to be a mistake, busted coverage.
Yeah, James Howard rolled up, but he knocked him clear out of bounds, and right now that makes a lot less room, and who cares if he catches the ball now?
Bob Oy is the injured man from Fullerton State, the senior out of Whittier, California, number 65, who is down. And there's still a discussion going on about that last play. Referee did not turn on his microphone. They are ruling, apparently, that the ground caused the fumble, and they've given the ball to San Jose State.
Professional football, you can come back in and catch it. The rule would have to be, obviously, he was out of bounds, that if he's bumped out of bounds, he can come back in and catch the ball.
So it is first and 10 for the Spartans. Randy Walker wide to the right side. Out to the left side, Rafa Malalulu, a little dive play. Walker cracks it inside the 10, down to the 9-yard line. In the grasp of the right side defensive end, Mark Chuzma. Junior out of San Bernardino.
Titans roll up both corners that time and they're playing extremely tight on the goal line in a double corner roll with two on top. And we're anticipating the run, did an excellent job of stuffing San Jose.
Meredith, 32, the junior checks in. Tatum is the fullback. Carlson bends in on second down and a long eight. Thomas motion, top of your screen. Misdirection, Carlson looks, fires behind his man. Good catch at the 10-yard line. Meredith out of the backfield, and now it's ruled incomplete. Russ Mayberry, the man that stripped the ball loose of Mike Meredith.
Mayberry does an excellent job. They're all locked on in man coverage, and you can see Mayberry running from his inside linebacker position to cover the back coming out of the backfield. Does a very, very fine job on coverage that far outside. The entire coverage to that side of the field was very tight by the secondary and Mayberry.
John Carlson, the senior quarterback for San Jose State, now 4 out of 8, 66 yards and one interception, looks at 3rd and 7. Meredith motions top of your screen. Looks in the end zone, slips and falls, and then down in the grasp of Ruben Lizarralu, senior out of Pico Rivera, California. 6'5", 250. He loves pizza. Does he look like it?
He looks like he has eaten very well. Looks like we've got a holding penalty here. We got the motion outside, and once again, Fullerton really did an excellent job of covering all the way across the field. Each individual locked on in man coverage, running in face, and Carlson really had no place to go with the football.
Holding on the offense, it has been declined.
So the penalty is declined, and it brings on the field goal team for San Jose State, and their senior kicker out of Victoria, British Columbia, Tony Brown. 3 out of 4 in the field goal department, 4 out of 5 in the point after. Certainly well within his range this year. His longest has been 47 yards. Out of the hold of Doug Allen, the backup quarterback. From the 20, this is a 30-yard field goal try that is blocked. Allen covers it, and it brings up 1st and 10. Fullerton State, their defense comes up with a big play, and in the middle of things, watch number 65, or check it, number 78. That is Ruben Lizarragua, right there.
Really, there wasn't such a bad job of blocking. There just wasn't much lift on the ball. Lizarragua blocked it from right on the line of scrimmage. That's a very tough thing to do if you get any lift on the football. So I think that the lineman shouldn't really totally be at blame in that case.
The score, nothing, nothing. Now we'll return to Spartan Stadium after this timeout.
Where is that sketch? Here's that beach resort Liz wants to visit. Acapulco Plaza. 6 restaurants, 5 bars, non-stop action. Or nothing at all. Privacy. Relaxation. Acapulco.
Dave, can you pick up line 3?
Hold my calls. I've got some unfinished business. In Acapulco.
Acapulco Plaza. Call your travel agent or 1-800-HOLIDAY.
All right. You know, that was a great football game. The greatest part was that I knew the winner before the game even started. I called the players' action line. They predicted the results before the game. Now, how do they know the winner before the game? Well, that reminds me. Got to call them again. There's another game on in just a few minutes. Remember, call 976-1234 for the players' action line, the greatest source for winning sports information.
There is Ruben Lizarragua, the man that blocked that field goal try. 6'5", 250, the man we said loved pizza. He wants to be a firefighter when his college days are over. Very have to build the firehouse around him.
Did an excellent job of getting the big old hand up and away of the football from the line of scrimmage.
Around the left side, Burness Scott, the game breaker, but they managed to do a good job of containing him. And you know, Miles, Fullerton State has been running primarily to the left side, and San Jose State has been sniffing it out.
Thus far, Cal State Fullerton has been very conservative in their approach, and they have had relatively poor field position. We would look for them to still begin to pull it out and show us some things that would be more of the gimmick nature.
Corn Reddick, top of your screen. Allen Pitts to the bottom, and the eye pro set, Burness Scott and Bo White. Tailback on a dive behind the block by the fullback, Bo White. Burness Scott, a math major at Fullerton State. Played for UCLA back in 82, averages about 4 yards per carry, but watch Jimmy Priest, number 58, and Stevenson. Mark Stevenson, 74, on the pulling guard.
Stevenson pulls out, does a fine job of making his block. San Jose does an excellent job of just bopping it all the way down the line of scrimmage, and there really is much that Fullerton is doing to bring him out of the defense at this time.
Pitch back. They try the right side. Scott cuts it inside behind Bo White's block, and an excellent penetration by K.C. Clark, the junior out of Sacramento, California, the most experienced defensive back in the secondary for San Jose State, and it showed, Mouse, on that play.
He is a very strong young man and an excellent player, although right at this time, Cal State Fullerton's making it a little easier for San Jose to tee off on him.
Freddie Payton is back deep, anticipating this punt by Jim Sirois. Line of scrimmage to 28. Blitz just got it away, and he gets away a beauty. He hangs it up high. Payton backpedals, loses the ball, and then gets buried at the 23-yard line. And a late penalty flag. Mouse, why the late flag?
I think the crowd may have intimidated him a bit. Certainly the ball was loose. The kid was going for the ball. He's going to end up calling a spear on the kid. And that's unfortunate. It was one of those things that Kelly Ross is flying down the field, number 11. Does an excellent job of covering. He's very excited to get the football. Payton drops it. Payton recovers it. They're both going for it. And now we get the spear call.
Now watch. Right, the ball here is loose, and Kelly Ross is going for the ball. He's already in midair.
Covered. And Kelly, you can't see it on the replay, but Kelly was already launched himself. It was one of those where it appeared as though the official reacted to the crowd.
On the kicking team, first down.
I would say a marginal call at best. You can't stop yourself when you're in midair flight going for a loose football.
Flying for the loose football is very difficult.
5:34 left. It's still nothing, nothing. We've had two interceptions, some fumbles, and a blocked field goal. A little trap over the left side for Mike Meredith. And the blocking there by David DeInfantani and Don Teague, the center.
Meredith did an excellent job when he hit the hole of making a little wiggle to the inside and nearly broke it for a big play.
There is John Carlson. And now we've got a timeout with 5:05 to go. Line of scrimmage, the 45-yard line of the Spartans, second down and four. You know, you expect Carlson to try to loosen up this Fullerton State defense just a little bit. He's got excellent wide receivers, especially number three, Manalulu.
We were talking prior to the game about Eric Cal. As far as the whole PCAA is concerned, thus far we've had very few footballs in the air from the white shirts. Carlson has thrown the ball a great deal more. I would look for both teams to start putting it up a great deal more.
Four wide receivers in now. Todd Cage, 81. Gary Satterfield, 26. Kenny Nash and Lafo. Tatum on a dive. Keith Tatum, the fullback out of Bakersfield, California. 6'2", 270 pounds.
Well, we got a good look at Bill Bryan coming in and doing a good job submarine, finding the hole, and excellent tackle by Bill Bryan.
Coming out wide to the left side now is number 39, Steve Johnson out of Oxnard, California. Third and one. Backs are split. Tatum and Payton. 49. Carlson audibilizes. Student body left. And a host of student bodies from Fullerton State were there to greet him. Jim Bayou leading the charge. The nose tackle out of Riverside, California. And Russ Mayberry. Watch 51 and 99 on the defense here and the penetration for Fullerton State.
Just a lead sweep week. Payton is the lead blocker, but by the time he got to the ball carrier, got the line of scrimmage, there was also so much penetration inside, the play didn't have a chance to develop.
Warren Reddick is back deep, anticipating this punt. Doug Allen bangs a beauty inside the 10 to about the 9, and going the wrong way is Reddick. Looks to get a block. He is trapped, and it is a safety. Or he is trapped at the goal line. Safety. Brett Grouse, the senior out of Terra Linda, California. And what was Reddick thinking?
I think Reddick lost sight of where he was. He started up, and now as he's catching the football, he moves back. I don't think he realized where he was on the field. He should have let the thing go into the end zone. After he catches the ball, then he does a dance. Back inside, catch the ball inside the 5, runs parallel line of scrimmage, now attempting to get back outside, runs all the way into the end zone, and safety for San Jose.
Excellent play by Brett Grouse. Watch the penetration. Now watch running backwards. He's at the 8, then you'll see the 5-yard line right there, and then he runs step
out, better let it go. Excellent punt by Allen, number four, this backup quarterback and punter from San Jose.
And the frustration all over the face of that man, Gene Murphy, as you saw him kneel down there, because his defense of Fullerton State, very suspect, played a very good first quarter.
In fact, both teams have really played very well on defense. Neither have shown a great deal at this point on offense, although San Jose has had some big plays and has put the football up a great deal more.
So it is 2-0. Spartans, top of the first inning.
Yes, indeed. We got a pitcher's duel going.
3:41 left to go here in San Jose, and the Spartans break on top 2-0. I understand we have had some technical difficulties. Jim Sirwa off the side of his foot. Penalty flag is down, and the Spartans will come out of this with great field position just about at midfield.
Would you say that the kicking game is becoming pivotal in this contest?
Illegal procedure.
Kicked it out of bounds. All they'll do is just line up and start the drive from right there.
The Spartans, of course, are 1-3.
Procedure on the kicking team, kicking out of bounds, decline, first down.
First down blue, the Spartans are in blue, just shy of the midfield stripe. So two mistakes, as Mouse pointed out, in the kicking game, very costly for Gene Murphy's Titans.
In a contest like this, the kicking game really becomes pivotal.
Kenny Nash, 89, wide to the left side. In motion, that is 81, Todd Cage, top of your screen as Carlson bends in and backpedals. Man is open, and it is caught. Todd Cage, watch the concentration. The defensive player went for the interception. Mark Collins, the consensus All-American, the senior, who should be a number one draft pick in the NFL, but Todd Cage, an excellent high school basketball player, kept his eye on the ball, and it all will go for naught.
All will go for naught. Ball probably should not have been thrown. Safety was coming hard to Cage. Cage made a great catch. One of those that could have been a pick, but as you say, it all goes for naught. Certainly the coverage was there. Ball was in a position where either the defender or Cage could have caught the football.
10-yard penalty, still first down.
Well, Fullerton State gets a break, and they could use one at this point to try to pick their team up a little bit. 3:35 left to go in a scoreless first quarter as far as Fullerton State is concerned. Spartans of San Jose State lead 2-0. Dive over the left side goes to Freddie Payton out of Bryan, Texas. Russ Mayberry from Covina, California, 3-year letterman for Gene Murphy's Titans, in on the hit. Mayberry, whom you're looking at right there, is quite an artist. He designed the logo on the Titan team helmets. Second and 17. Slot to the right, wide to the left side. Kenny Nash. Post pattern, Nash incomplete, and the ball was misfired by Carlson. And Tom Phillips, the sophomore free safety out of Redlands, California, who had an interception earlier in this game, was back there in the coverage.
Put him out to there, roll up the corner and played the half field safety into the slant. Had he caught the ball, he would have had Phillips in his face immediately. There's a small crease to throw that football in that hole, but certainly it's going to be a headache for the wide receiver if he catches it.
Kenny Nash comes out wide to the left side and the slot to the right. Gary Satterfield and Cortez Thomas. Third and 17. Blair goes to Freddie Payton. Payton needs a block. Upended at the 47-yard line on a great defensive play by Sean Foy, the co-captain for the Titans, the junior out of Placenta, California. 12 solo tackles for a minus 56 yards last year. Watch number 90 come in.
We can see Carlson dropping back, faking the draw. Now throws the screen outside. We got two good blocks up inside. Phillips is the first one to get there. Now Mayberry comes flying across, as does Foy. All number 90, all three of them played very well against the screen. Stopped it short of the first down.
A chance for Corn Reddick to atone for his past mistake, number 18. He was trapped in the end zone. Allen, he hangs it high, and this one should sail into the end zone. Airborne, he airmail delivered that one.
Got so another flag down, Jim.
Penalty flag is down at the line of scrimmage, so a penalty flag to be checked out. 2:09 left to go here in quarter number one. And we expected a wide open offensive explosion. The Titans have played it very tight to the vest.
If they're going to get her rolling, I believe they're going to have to do something other than just toss pitch, because certainly San Jose has stuffed their running game convincingly.
Oh, my. Holding against Fullerton State.
One of the worst kind of penalties.
So instead of first and 10, your possession at the 20, Miles, what happens?
Well, now the situation is San Jose's going to come back out and have the football again. And instead of you having the football first down and 10 yards to go at your 20, now they're going to be very close to the first down. In fact, it might even be enough for the first down. Should be enough for the first down. Now, for the first down, now San Jose's drive is alive. They kept the thing going. Worst penalty in football right there.
On the defense.
Terrible situation to have that penalty occur.
There is Claude Gilbert, the head coach. San Jose State leading 2-0. Carlson in at quarterback. Backs are split. Tatum and Payton. Carlson with an audible. Loose football, and it's recovered by Fullerton State. Keith Payton, the senior fullback, who only carried the ball 9 times last year, coughed up the loose football, and it was recovered by that man, number 84, Ted Hinton.
Here's that same lead sweep again, and they have not been able to cut off the penetration inside. Here we can see Ted Hinton once again shooting the gap inside. Hinton has done an excellent job, number 84 for the Titans, of blowing the gap inside and being disruptive in the backfield.
An error-filled first quarter for both teams. Pitchback, here comes the sweep to the right. Todd White, now the option pass, wide open is Reddick. Corn Reddick.
And he had either one of them open for a touchdown, Jim. Wide open.
Kevin Jan, the quarterback, handed off to number 21, Todd White, and wide open was that man, Corn Reddick, the senior, who had over 1,072 yards in receptions.
Also, Wade Lockett was wide open. Both of them had no one. In fact, Lockett was even more wide open than Reddick. And out comes the playbook, out comes the gimmicks, and we may now begin to see a little shift from Cal State Fullerton.
Todd White, number 21, who threw the pass, will hold. Len Strandley, the junior place kicker out of Tacoma, Washington, will bang it through the uprights, and it's perfect. So after making lots of mistakes, watch number 21, Todd White, fire the football. He's the tailback. It looks like a run play. The safeties come up. They play the run. Airmail special delivery. Watch how wide open number 18 is. That's
17 is over on this side of the field. Lockett, and he is also wide open. The whole secondary sucked up.
Another look. You see the secondary pulling up, anticipating run.
There you can see 17 to the right of your screen, wide open.
That's Stacy Gilchrist, who was open, but instead it goes to Lockett, or to Reddick. 7-2, bottom of the first. 1:57 left to go in quarter number one. Just about to ask what Gene Murphy will do, the head coach. His team, the penalty, gave San Jose State a first down. Another penalty by, or mistake by Reddick, gave him the safety. You've got to correct those mental mistakes quickly, or you're not going to be in the ball game very long.
And I think what Murphy really did, the minute he got into good field position, then he pulled one out, and as we saw, the result was a touchdown. He's been playing very conservative, hit into the field. He got across that 50, and big play for the Titans.
1:57 left to go in this first quarter. From the 40-yard line, number 4 for Fullerton State, Len Strandley will tee it up. He has got a very powerful leg. Good weight program over the summer. Stephon Crawford, number 22, and Freddie Payton, 21, back deep in the end zone. Strandley booms a beauty. It is high and it is deep, and Payton will field 6 yards deep and say no thank you. Saturday, October 5th at 7:30 Eastern Time, the number one team in the nation, the Auburn Tigers, meet Mississippi in our live CFA Game of the Week. It could be college football's best game so far this year. It, of course, will feature the Heisman Trophy candidate and national rushing leader Bo Jackson against one of the best and most stingy defenses in the country. Through the third week of the season, Bo Jackson led the nation in scoring as well, but quarterback Kent Austin and split receiver J.R. Ambrose have placed Ole Miss in the top 10 in passing, scoring, and total offense. Bo Southeastern Conference claims a top 10 spot in rushing, passing defense, and scoring defense, and total defense as well. First and 10, San Jose State, they trail 7-2. Incomplete at the 27-yard line for Cortez Thomas. Those are the ones, Mouse Davis, you've got to pull in. You can't hear those footsteps.
Well, certainly that's true. Romero, number 40, was sitting right on top of Cortez Thomas, and the minute the ball was thrown, he broke to the football. We had Brian, number 88, coming inside out, and had the ball been caught, it would have been, again, a headache after about a three-yard gain. Very fine defense thus far by Fullerton.
Tatum, the fullback, goes in motion. A miss exchange, loose football. It's still loose, and it is recovered by San Jose State at the 20-yard line. Freddie Payton and John Carlson, just a missed exchange, and nobody wanted that hot potato.
Fortunate there that the ball is not turned over to Cal State Fullerton. You can see Carlson turns, steps outside, and the rush upfield by Tom Tatum flushed him out of the pocket immediately. Number 95, Tom Tatum, was the man that created all the confusion.
Bruce McElvain recovered the loose football. Carlson airborne on third and 10, and he's got his man at the 33, and that should be a first down. Stephen Crawford out of Rico, California, a Riverside Junior College redshirt in 84, came up with that reception. Nine catches, 109 yards last year, one touchdown.
Watch number 22, Crawford, does a fine job, as Malo had done earlier, keeping his feet in just as he catches the football. That's the way you draw it up.
Lafo Malalulu has not been in there. He is back in the lineup now, slotted out to the top of the screen. Tatum in motion. Carlson, draw play. Freddie Payton, stutter steps, across the 35. Hammered down near the 40-yard line in the grasp of Bill Bryan.
San Jose now has run that play twice where they put the back in motion, so they end up with a single back and now drop back and run the draw. It's done an effective job of spreading the Cal State Fullerton defense, and each time they run it, they have had a 5 to 7 yard gain.
Second down and 5. There goes Freddie Payton. That's a first down for San Jose State at the 45. 10 hitting on the tackle, the sophomore from Los Angeles. Watch the offensive line. Watch 63, David Diaz Infantani and Mike Session, number 60.
Now, Brian pretty well stands him up, but does an excellent job by Payton, number 21, of wiggling through that hole. Brian really had a fine collision with Diaz Infantani.
Injured player for Fullerton State down in the backfield. Well, hockey on ESPN makes its debut on Thursday, October the 10th at 7:30 Eastern Time. It'll come to you live from Madison Square Garden in New York. Ted Sather makes his debut as the new New York Rangers coach, and the Washington Capitals, a very pesky club from last year, much improved. I'll be your host on site. Tom Meese back in the studio. And, of course, with us, Dan Kelly, one of the best hockey play-by-play announcers to ever come down the pike, and our expert color analyst throughout the season, Brad Park, a former Boston Bruin, a former New York Ranger, and just retired Detroit Red Wing, along with Mickey Redmond. Watch 99 white, Russ Mayberry. Gets twisted and turned as Freddie Payton does a little high hurdle act.
Michael Session came off the ball very well and drives right at the knee. You can see the knee extend backwards, hyperextension of the knee on Mayberry. He was fortunate he didn't get it locked in, a serious hyperextension. It was a fine block on the other hand by Michael Session.
That will be a big loss for head coach Gene Murphy. Number 99, 6'3", 218 pounds, a three-year letterman, Russ Mayberry.
Mayberry thus far has been flying around the field and been a big play maker for the Titans. They surely will miss him.
And that does not look good.
That was a fairly severe hyperextension. And the young man certainly appears to be in pain at this time.
And you know, he has been so banged up. The injury list for Russ, we had a chance to talk to him yesterday. He was such a nice young man. He's had shoulder injuries, a knee injuries, a broken hand. Wants to be a graphic artist one day.
This one could be a very serious one.
First and 10, loose football, and Carlson falls on it. You would think this game, Mouse, was being played in a driving rainstorm. Nobody can hang on to the football.
They have not looked well-oiled to this point, have they?
Well, they have looked well-oiled. The football looks greased up.
Okay, I'll give you that one.
You can't use stick'em, though. Time winding down in quarter number one. The Spartans had a safety when Reddick was trapped in the end zone. He made amends, however, on the halfback option pass. A toss from Todd White, and the Titans lead 7-2 after the first quarter of play. Live from San Jose, it's a special Thursday night edition of College Football on ESPN.
This bud's for all you guys who know it's how you play the game.
This bud's for you. There's no one else who makes them move the way you do.
Come your way.
So here's to you. For all you do, the king of beers is coming through.
Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do. This bud's for you.
Look how water can destroy unprotected wood, but not if it's protected with Thompson's Water Seal. Use Thompson's Water Seal waterproofer on dozens of surfaces. Brush on Thompson's for an invisible barrier that helps prevent water from entering and damaging brick, wood, and concrete. Your house isn't really protected until it's protected with Thompson's Water Seal. Many stores now have special values on Thompson's Water Seal.
Once you start listening to a Delco music system, you'll never want to stop. Nothing else sounds quite like Delco because it's specifically designed to match the acoustics of your very own GM truck while it's still on the drawing board. Delco Electronics delivers sound so true, you just can't be lured away from it. Delco designed in sound. You'll love it too much to leave it.
Fullerton State over San Jose State. Opening snap, quarter number two, live from Spartan Stadium here in San Jose, California, on a Thursday night edition of College Football on ESPN. I'm Jim Kelly, and Mouse Davis, head coach of the USFL Denver Gold, alongside. Backpedaling is John Carlson, senior quarterback, airs it out, looks for a man, and it is incomplete at the 20-yard line. Mark Collins, who had four interceptions against Pacific in 1983, had one in his breadbasket that time, Mouse, and it dropped it.
The Titans brought all the bodies that time, had a full blitz, had man cover locked on, and Collins does an excellent job of turning, running with the football, and he's got Malo just covered as well as you can cover receiver. Had an opportunity to intercept the football and dropped it, but he had very fine coverage.
Third and 11 for the Titans. Or the Spartans check. Carlson unloads to Freddie Payton.
Whoop.
And there is a fine open field tackle by Ted Hinton, number 84.
Exactly the same play they ran a bit ago when Payton made the big play. They faked the draw, run the screen outside, and Hinton, who's having himself a night, number 84, makes an excellent play on Payton.
There is Corn Reddick, who I'll bet is checking the yardage markers to find out where he is.
I think he's got room this time. Although Allen has really been rooting the ball.
Allen, his sophomore punter, his backup quarterback, averaging about. Here comes the blitz. Look out. He gets it away. This one is short, however. Reddick with a fair catch at the 23. So the Titans, who lead 7-2, will have it first and 10, 14-11 to go before halftime.
G'day. Now, it's come to my attention that some Americans still don't know where Australia is. Well, I'll tell you exactly where it is. Australia is where the sun shines on thousands of miles of the world's great beaches. It's where you can go bush and get away from it all. Or just stay in town and get amongst it all. It's where wild native animals roam free in the untamed Australian outback. G'day, killer. It's where the fish are friendly and even the birds have a sense of humour. Now, if you still don't know where Australia is, it's a pretty sure bet you know where your phone is. So pick it up and call this number toll-free for a copy of the Aussie Holiday Book. And when someone says, where are you going for your holidays? Say Australia. Oh, and if they say, where's that? Tell them it's where the America's Cup is.
Tonight's ESPN telecast between Fullerton State and San Jose State is brought to you by IBM and the growing family of IBM personal computers. Miles Davis uses a computer when he's got that run-and-gun offense out there in Denver.
Try to total them all up.
You're in the right city. The ball just stays in the air out there.
The mile high.
First and 10, Titans. They lead 7-2. Kevin Jan goes airborne and misfires. That was closer to the tuba section than it was to the intended receiver. And Wayne Woodard, number 92, was back there putting pressure on that man, Kevin Jan. Well, it's not exactly Jimmy Brown versus Walter Payton on the ground, is it?
Tell you what, the rushing game has been fairly well stuffed by both teams. And I think we'll see a little more pass orientation, although thus far Cal State Fullerton has been content to run when they're down in here. Now they go with the single back look.
Lone running back, Mark Hood, number 35 out of Long Beach. Reddick motions across, now open in the slot. Reddick with a loose football, first down and more. Corn Reddick out of Los Angeles beat Larry Weldon, the junior free safety out of San Jose. Turned it inside, looked like it was going to be a post pattern. Turned it back outside.
We see Reddick come across the motion. He comes back now as he starts up the field. He starts a little dip like he's going to make the move into the backers. Now he comes right back outside and hits him. The quarterback didn't ever take his eyes off Reddick. He's going to Reddick all the way. Reddick, outstanding athlete, a very fine receiver, a big play guy.
And the linebacker on the coverage, Kurt Lyon, number 54. Boy, anytime you get those wide receivers on a linebacker, you've got a completion. Misdirection play, Rick Calhoun. Across the 45, hammers his way up to the 47-yard line. And we told you at the top of the telecast about Rick Calhoun. He's built like a fullback, but he's got tailback-like speed.
Very fine job of the offensive line at Cal State Fullerton that day. Had a beautiful crease to run the football in. You could have made 4 yards on that. Now he made 6.
If I go on a diet, I could.
With fear in your heart.
Second and 4. Wide open. Wade Lockett wrestled out of bounds, but not before the Titans get another first down. Marcus McDade on the coverage. A very simple pattern, Mouse.
Yeah, all they're doing is they run Reddick across, Lockett across in motion. He does a little flat out, and they're finding a way to get the football to that bevy of talented receivers, and they're moving the football extremely well in this drive. This is the first thing that has looked like a drive since we started the ball game for Cal State Fullerton.
You saw the man on the sideline, Gene Murphy, the head coach, his Titans out in front by that score, 7-2. I pro set, Mark Hood the fullback, Rick Calhoun the tailback. Audibilized now, they change the play. And they change it correctly. Open man, James Pruitt, the senior out of Los Angeles, a co-captain with 4-5 speed. Larry Weldon, the free safety on the hit.
The corner was back so far off Pruitt that the quarterback just audible to the hitch. Had plenty of room to throw the football. Pruitt catches the football and the result is a nice 7-yard, 8-yard gain.
What kind of defensive adjustment should they make, should any team make, when you've got the corners playing that far off the wide receiver?
Well, if they start hitting you with a hitch, just what San Jose is doing right now, they've got themselves now where they're rolling up both corners. And on the snap of the football, they're going to take away. Well, they didn't.
Draw play.
They dropped
inside
back
it
off
goes
and
to
stayed in man.
Mark Hood on the draw play, blocking up front by the left guard, number 64, Darrell Titsworth. And watch number 74, Mark Stevenson. David Martinez, the center, number 52. And here come the linebackers for San Jose. Lyon is number 54 for the Spartans. Kurt Lyon out of Sacramento.
Kurt Lyon does a very fine job just continuing to stay with him, playing off the block and making the big play. Lyon has played very well this evening.
From the I pro set, they split the backs, Hood and Calhoun. Kevin Jan wants a touchdown, left corner incomplete. Alan Pitts, the intended receiver, number 23, and Stacy Gilchrist, the senior out of Redondo Beach, California, back there on the coverage, but that was just a badly thrown ball.
Yeah, probably badly read play, too. 23 Pitts has taken a run, a takeoff pattern, run a fade outside. They were anticipating getting the roll corner. The corner just continued to back up. All the quarterback could really do, if he's going to go to that single receiver, was do what he did, overthrow, throw it out of bounds so that they couldn't make the interception.
Second and 10. But what happens when the quarterback has it preset in his mind who he's going to throw to?
Gives a result just like you saw.
Penalty flags. It looks like flag day all over the place. And I think the left tackle, Ed Gillis, might have jumped.
Cal State Fullerton is going to do a great deal more single back, double slot look and running motion, having a great deal of success of getting their receivers open. Now they have to be able to hit them. Should have very good success. They continue this approach.
There is Gene Murphy. He was a little bit like Rodney Dangerfield yesterday. His Titans don't get no respect.
Murph is a great one. He certainly was one of the hottest coaching commodities in the game last season. Has a great personality, great rapport with the players. Has a lot of fun coaching the game. Plus a lot of success. You kind of root for a guy like that to have continued success.
Well, he seems to have a lot of fun coaching the game. A great rapport with the players.
Certainly does.
Second down. 10 yards to go for the Titans. 11:53 and counting left in the first half. Backs are split. Calhoun and Hood. Open man. The ball thrown behind the receiver. Looping out of the backfield was Todd White. Now, Todd White has thrown a 60-yard touchdown to Corn Reddick, which put the Titans ahead 7-2. That time, the ball was thrown behind the intended receiver. And it looks like Kevin Jan makes up his mind as he's taking the snap who he's going to throw to. I've not seen him look off to the secondary receiver.
And on some of the three-step drop stuff like that, you know, you pretty well do look at one receiver and then come to a secondary receiver. That time, the receiver was open, and he just threw the ball very poorly.
Third and 15. Motion across by Alan Pitts. Blitz is on. Kevin Jan reads it, unloads. Safety valve to Reddick. Reddick with running room gets a block. First down, he's off to the races. Reddick with a convoy will score.
A great deal of the credit should go to quarterback on that play. They put the blitz on. They're really coming hard. Priest is right in his face. He turns, dumps it over the top, and then it's a lot of athletic ability by Reddy. Watch him put the jets on right now.
See him give him the hip and take it away, and then bingo.
Now he's off to the races. He's a fine-looking stallion.
I want to tell you something about that thoroughbred, Corn Reddick. He averages 19 yards per catch. Snap, spot, kick is perfect by Stanley. And all of a sudden, Corn Reddick, that man who was trapped in the end zone for a safety, has been on the touchdown twice for Fullerton State.
If you're waiting to buy a personal computer, you may have questions about power, expandability, and dollars and cents. For the complete answer, take a close look at IBM. An IBM PC runs thousands of programs, expands easily, and prices are better than ever. So don't wait. Once you take the first step, the rest come easy. IBM Personal Computers.
Ladies and gentlemen, the heavyweight champion of the work.
Dickies Work Clothes. It's the best-selling work set in America because it's made of the heaviest, toughest fabric in America, fortified with Fortrell. We don't have to knock out the competition. We wear them out. Dickies, the heavyweight champion of the work. Dickies makes everything in work clothes. But who says you have to work in them?
The goat horns are gone. 14-2, and all of the scoring on both sides by that man.
Reddick thus far has certainly not only made the difference, he has swung the momentum of the game to the Murphs, and they're looking more like an excitable team that might be a defending champion rather than what they've been doing the first three ball games of the season. All would be forgiven, I'm sure, by all of those backing Fullerton if they continued this kind of play.
Spradley about set to tee it from the 40-yard line. A low line drive kick. Bounces around. Look out. Loose football. Peyton will have to pick it up. And he's going to be caught down at the 2-yard line. Great special teams effort by Fullerton State. As that old friend of yours, momentum has swung the other way. Todd White down there on the coverage. And an injured player for Fullerton State back at the 33-yard line.
Now,
watch Todd White, a little indecision. He was doing his Corn Reddick impersonation. First thing you've got to do is get the ball. Now we're going to go right.
I tell you,
now we're going to go left.
Everything is starting to fall the Titans' way.
Now we're going to go down.
Very close to the G line.
Watch number 82 for Fullerton State, Mark Chisholm, the junior out of San Bernardino.
I would say that that young man probably got knocked cold. It was a head-to-head, and the bells are ringing, the stars are shooting, and I'm sure the young man will be fine, but that was a great head-to-head shot.
He went head-to-head with number 99, Robert Cavaretta, out of Methuen, Mass. 14-2, Titans lead.
When night falls, the stars begin to shine. On America's greatest nighttime sport, harness racing. Join the millions who know a sure thing when they see it. They know that harness racing has it all. The color, the action, and the high-powered excitement happening in prime time. You'll enjoy it in beautiful surroundings, watching the trotters and pacers race to the winner's circle. Be part of it and cheer for the stars when they come out at a harness track near you.
For everyone working to keep the customer satisfied.
This Bud's for you. Nobody else can do the job the way you do. So here's to you. For all you do, the King of Beers is coming through.
Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do, this Bud's for you.
George Grant reminding you, at halftime, we'll take a look at all the baseball scores and also preview this weekend's big CFA football game on ESPN. That all comes at halftime when I'm joined by Bob Lee. Now back to football.
You see the time left in our first half here at Spartan Stadium in San Jose, where the home team has fallen behind 14-2. And watch right there, number 82, Mark Chisholm out of San Bernardino, California. And boom, right there, Robert Cavaretta out of Methuen, Massachusetts. And Chisholm is still down in the vicinity of the 30-yard line, being attended to by the trainer and the medical staff of Fullerton
State.
A hit
like that is like getting hit by a very strong Joe Lewis. That was, no question, a real bell ringer.
Well, we've got lots more Thursday night football here on ESPN. Mouse and I will be in Las Vegas. The Running Rebels take on New Mexico State. It'll be a special trick-or-treat on Halloween night for you. And then, of course, we will see Eddie Robinson, the legendary Eddie Robinson. My, what a career, a great career with a Grambling team. They'll take on South Carolina State. And then the caravan continues November 21st, Wichita State against Fresno State. You like Fresno State. You think they've got a great team.
I think Jim Sweeney has done a tremendous job of developing a program that continues to be a winner year after year. They have great skill players. Kevin Sweeney, their fine quarterback, continues to be impressive. And anytime you're undefeated, everyone looks at you and thinks you're a pretty good ball club, and we're no different. Now, because of the
care that they're now administering the young man on the field would lead you to believe there could possibly be some kind of a problem other than a concussion.
The man is Mark Chisholm, and you saw in that shot the ambulance. And of course, this is something you never like to see in any sport. Mark is just a junior, played his high school ball at the Pacific out of San Bernardino, California. He's been a very important part of the Titan defense the last 2 years. He started regularly in 83, and he was 10th on the team in tackles with 41 last year. He was a three-year letterman in high school and football, and he received the coach's award for attitude and inspiration. So you know why everybody is so concerned about Mark Chisholm right now. 11:30 left to go before halftime. 14-2. We'll return to Spartan Stadium after this timeout.
If you're looking for excitement, Anaheim Toyota Maserati has just what you're looking for. Come in and test drive the new Maserati Bi-Turbo and compare its value against any other sports coupe on the road today. Boasting the driving force of a twin-turbocharged 185-horsepower engine, this Eurosport also features luxurious leather interior, air conditioning, a technically pure sound system, and more, all standard and all for just $24,999. Anaheim Toyota Maserati, Anaheim Boulevard, off the 5 freeway left at Cerritos. Come share the excitement.
Every 18 seconds, a woman gets beaten in this country. 39% of all high school seniors are problem drinkers. Mental disorders will disrupt the lives of 19% of American adults in the next 6 months. Our difficulties sometimes sound insurmountable. They're not. If you want to do something about our problems, remember, the way to stop them is to become united. United Way. Thanks to you, it works for all of us.
Back live at San Jose, they're still attending to Mark Chisholm. And for friends and family, he has been moving both of his legs.
He moved them very well. They've been very careful in putting the young man on the stretcher. Because he moved his legs so well, I thought possibly he may have had a broken face mask or something that created a problem. Really, we don't know the seriousness at this point.
Let's take another look at the hit. It is number 82 there, Mark Chisholm, and number 99 comes in, Robert Cavaretta.
It's a very clean head-to-head shot. Both of them see each other cleanly. Now bang. And yep. You can see that as both helmets hit, that it appears as if the young man is out before he hits the ground. Now they're very careful in administering the first aid. At this point, he's moving both
legs. You can see the arms.
Both hands. So I've got to believe it's something to do with a head injury. Possibly break a mask and cut the face, something of that nature.
Well, our people will go into the Fullerton State locker room and we will have an update as to the exact medical condition of that young man, Mark Chisholm. And he is quite an inspirational young man. We told you about the coach's award. He was the defensive player of the year and team captain as a senior in high school, the coach's award for attitude and inspiration. And you would imagine that would spill over to a Murphy coach team, because there is the coach right there who's as concerned as anybody. He's very close to his players.
I'm sure that this could be one of those things that will bring all the players a little closer at this time. Can be either a momentum getter or a momentum breaker. I'm glad to see the carefulness with which they're handling the injury. I think extremely important, and they appear to have done everything as correctly and with as much care as possible for the safety of Mark Chisholm.
And a very nice reception by the hometown San Jose Spartan fan. Miles Scott, I ask you a couple of questions from a coaching standpoint now. We have been without football for a good 10 minutes. The momentum was definitely swinging for Cal State Fullerton. They lead 14-2. They've had a couple of big plays, but now they've been quiet. And now they've got to be concerned with their friend and teammate, Mark Chisholm. You wonder how it's going to affect them the rest of the way.
The field position that San Jose ends with or starts with at this time, certainly is a major factor, makes him into a conservative position. But you must get yourself jacked up and excited and ready to play the game now. They've had a long wait, so the next thing that happens may be the difference in turning the ball game for the rest of this quarter.
There is Gene Murphy, the head coach at Fullerton State, in his sixth year as the head man of the Titans, a record of 28-33. Eighth year as a head coach, his overall record is 43-40. And into the ambulance, number 82 for Cal State Fullerton, the junior Mark Chisholm. And again, we will have an exact medical update for you. 11 and a half to go before halftime. Numbed everyone in the stadium.
Certainly has. I'm sure that everyone is rooting for them to do it as slowly and as meticulously as possible for the safety of Mark Chisholm, and we'll get an injury report update as soon as possible.
Murphy's Titans ahead 14-2, 11 and a half to go before halftime. The line of scrimmage, the 1 yard line. On the attack, San Jose State. They trail it by 12. A quick out. Badly thrown ball is scooped up at the 7 yard line. Stephen Crawford with good concentration, and he beat Mark Collins. You don't see Collins beaten too often.
I like the approach that San Jose's using. They're coming out of the end zone, throwing the football. They must get it going. That's a very nice catch by Crawford on an underthrown ball, but you like the approach of, say, hey, let's not be too conservative here. We must get it going.
Second down and 5. Randy Walker, junior out of Los Angeles, in a tailback. Backpedaling is Carlson. Wide open and dropped is Todd Cage, the junior out of Pasadena, California.
Once again, a three-step drop, and Cage just got right in between the two half-field safeties. Wide open. Would have been a big play. Drops the football.
Third and 5 as Carlson breaks the huddle. Randy Walker is the tailback. Keith Tatum the fullback. And the wide receiver, Stephen Crawford, and Lapo Malalulu. That's close to and should be a first down. Crawford on the catch. James Howard on the covering.
James Howard was given an awful lot of room, and a quick out was there.
Word now from the Cal State Fullerton people on the condition of Mark Chisholm. They are indeed taking him to the hospital. It is a neck injury. We don't yet know the severity. They are taking x-rays for precaution and obviously to find out exactly how badly the neck is injured. And as soon as we get word from the hospital, we will pass it along. First and 10 Spartans. They trail 14-2, 11:50 and counting here in this first half. Carlson just gets the ball to Randy Walker. Boy, you talk about holding it on until the very last minute. Carlson was just about to go down.
Just had a down the line option with a man motion in front of it. And we can take a look at the play now as we see the motion man come across. We don't see him now. Wagner, number 5. Randy Walker is the man that receives the ball. Excellent job by Williams, who replaced Mayberry inside, number 57, of making the play on the option.
Meredith and Walker are the running backs. Carlson escapes a jam. Running room to spare. Dives across the 25, up near the 28. Ted Hinton make the tackle secure.
And this play, It's pass all the way. Carlson drops back. Now he steps up inside. You can't see it, but number 84, Hinton, is chasing the receiver up the field. Carlson is now chasing him. Now Hinton turns around to see Carlson make the first down.
Picks up a big first down inside of 10 minutes when the ball is snapped. Motion across by Todd Cave. Carlson wants the deep man, throws it, and it is incomplete at the 48-yard line. And the fans on the near sideline from San Jose State think that Mark Collins was over the back of Todd Cage, and you can't disagree.
I disagree. I think that it was a good, clean play here. 81's going to come up the field. Now, Collins is in perfect position. The ball is right there now. Watch Collins. He's right in it, and the ball is going right to him. I don't think that, if anything, both of them are right to the football.
Can't tell from that angle.
Collins, I think, was in perfect position to make the play, and Cage as well ran into him. It was a toss-up.
Incomplete, a misrun route. The wide receivers were crossing, and Carlson threw it to the corner.
Mallow ran a slant inside, and Cage ran a flat outside, and Carlson overthrew the slant.
There is Lafo Malalulu out of Oceanside, California, a business administration merit. Two-time All-American selection at the junior college level. 17 touchdowns, 122 passes for over 2,000 yards. Third and 10. Blitz is on. Carlson picks it up. Cage comes up with a reception at the 35-yard line. But that'll be about 2 yards shy of first down yardage, and a penalty flag is down, and so is Carlson.
Roughing the passer. That time Fullerton had Hinton walked out on the wide receiver. They had Romero in a strong safety look inside. Romero was the man on the coverage number 40. Very fine coverage, stopping short of the first down, but it's now going to be roughing the passer, and San Jose State will maintain the football.
Watch the late hit.
You can see plenty of time to stop, and it was obviously a flagrant roughing the passer. Looked like he hit Carlson right in the throat. And Carlson is still down.
Sean Foy, the co-captain of the Titans, the man that did the clothesline job on Carlson.
And very, very late.
Very late, but it's also out of character for Sean Foy.
Sean, as Murph explained to us yesterday, is one of those young men that you'd like to model your own sons after. He's just a great work ethic and a great person. And sometimes in the heat of the battle, you do get extremely excited. And in that case, Foy certainly was very flagrant in a late hit.
We have a personal foul on the defense. It's a first down.
Carlson's jaw was a lot like Michael Spinks coming into the game. He is still down and being attended to after the clothesline by Sean Foy. Now watch, the ball is released. Watch number 90 come in right now and kapow.
Looks like right in the throat area.
A cheap shot.
Certainly could be classified as that. That will bring on Doug Allen. Carlson, I would believe, will be back in a ball game, but he must have an opportunity for that to settle down a bit.
Doug Allen, you're looking at John Carlson as he goes off. He'll go over on the sideline, and they'll ask him where his hometown is, the name of his mom and dad.
And he said, let me spit this blood out of my throat, and then I'll tell you those stories, because that is a very, very sore one when you catch one in the Adam's apple.
Doug
Carlson
Allen
looks fine.
Doug Allen, who comes in, has attempted 89 passes, completed 39, 5 interceptions, 1 touchdown, his longest for 38 yards. Looks at a first and 10. Sean Foy fakes the blitz. Motion across by Todd Cage. Quick hitter, Randy Walker, across the 45, brings up second down and long. How about a rusty quarterback coming in? Didn't have much time to warm up. You're a run-and-gun kind of offense. And there's the book on John Carlson.
Well, certainly, Mr. Allen has excellent athletic ability. He doesn't have command of the offense like Carlson does. It turns him a little more into a run-oriented offense, than into the pass offense. Has a strong arm, but just does not have the ability to read as Carlson does. Here's a little boot action.
He can run behind the intended receiver, Todd Cage. Now, you might have noticed Doug Allen is a left-handed thrower. He's the first southpaw, we are told, in the known history of the Spartan football program here at San Jose State.
That's a second drop by Cage. He's wide open, and it would have been a big play. The ball was thrown a little behind, but he certainly could have made the play.
Doug Allen was the last player signed during the 84 recruiting period and the only freshman to make the traveling squad a year ago. He is very slender, 6 feet, 163 pounds, and there is the ice on the neck of John Carlson. Third and seven. Backs are split, Meredith and Walker. Here comes the blitz. Allen needs to unload, fires, got his man, and it is caught. Talk about concentration by Randy Walker. And finally, he bobbles the ball out of bounds, but that was a great extra effort.
He caught it and dropped it and caught it and dropped it and caught it and dropped it again. Now we can see five, Walker. Right here, he comes out the middle, slips to the outside in the flat, bobbles it once, bobbles it twice, bobbles it again. And now we're going to get another view. Again, bounces off his head, shoulder, back in his face mask, and he finally drops it.
Allen, the quarterback, now punting. Fair catch, and it is caught by Reddick at the 17-yard line. 8 minutes, 24 seconds left to go before halftime. There is John Carlson. The Stroh's 300 Auto Racing returns to ESPN on Sunday at 5 p.m. The word from the Spartan bench on Carlson, hit in the windpipe, expected to return. First and 10, Titans, they lead 14-2. Motion across by Wade Lockett, dives over the left side, Rick Calhoun. Wayne Woodard, the junior out of Jackson, California, the first Spartan to arrive. This is a very odd football game. It started out very mistake-prone. Fumbles, a safety, dropped passes, blocked field goal. Then we had two knockout punches delivered by each team.
Big swing and a kick game.
Backs are split. Bo White, Rick Calhoun, second and seven for Kevin Jan. Blitz is on. Jan reads it, unloads to Calhoun. He's got a convoy and a first down. Sam Kennedy, the junior out of Watersonville, California, missed most of last year with an ankle injury. Number 55 in there on the tackle, and watch the pursuit. He comes from all the way across the field.
Kevin Jan's doing an excellent job of setting that screen up. They got fine blocks, and if you have to come all the way across the field to make the play, you're always going to have a nice, fair game. Reddick curls to the inside. You can see now he's going to make the block right here on 54. Lyon inside.
First and 10 for the Titans. Reddick comes up with it at the 40. Shy of first down yardage by about 3 yards. And watch Corn Reddick with two touchdowns to his credit already.
Reddick's just going to come out, give a little fake. Now he's going to break right across the middle off a little turnout and back inside move. Wide open. Good concentration and double catching the ball.
So it brings up second down and a long three. Calhoun, first down, and more approaching midfield. Larry Weldon stopped the touchdown.
Cal State Fullerton appears to get a little of their running game going now. Get a little more movement. Their offensive line is beginning to dominate more up front. They're getting a little better crease to run in and playing with more confidence offensively than they started the game. A little momentum swinging in favor of the white shirts at this time.
Spartans have done a good job of containing that man, Rick Calhoun, the breakaway threat of Fullerton State. On first and 10, Reddick can throw, Reddick can run. Reddick with a block. out of bounds near the 41-yard line. Larry Weldon chased him out of bounds. Jim Thornton, number nine, with a big block on Sam Kennedy to set it up around the corner. Now watch. There goes Reddick. Let's see if we can pick up the block of number nine on number 55.
He showed excellent
right
patience
there
in avoiding the clip. And then Reddick does the rest of it on his own. Fine job by Thornton, the tight end, of holding the block and making it at the right moment.
You know, Reddick handled the ball just four times in 1982, but he averaged 31 yards on a pair of passes and a pair of rushes.
He's handled it a few more times tonight.
There's Kevin Jan conferring with Gene Murphy. For the Titans, they lead 14-2 with 6:11 to go. On Saturday, October the 5th, 7:30 Eastern Time, I'll be in Auburn along with Paul McGuire to bring you the Mississippi game, the Rebels with an outstanding air game, J.R. Ambrose and Kent Austin. They put Ole Miss in the top 10 in passing, scoring, and total offense. And, of course, Auburn, you know about. They've got the great Bo Jackson, but Pat Dye still looking for a quarterback. It's like, what's behind curtain number one, two, and three?
You know, Bo started off so strong, it's difficult to continue that kind of production. They've continued to search for that quarterback, and to be a great football team and a contender for the national championship, they've got to decide on one and have some productivity out of him.
6:11 left to go before halftime. And again, for the friends and family and everyone concerned about Mark Chisholm, number 82 for Fullerton State, they have taken Mark to the hospital. They are x-raying the neck. That is where the injury is. And as soon as we get a report from the hospital, we'll pass it along. First and 10 for the Titans. They lead 14-2. Lockett wide to the left side. And the eye pro set, Bo White and Rick Calhoun. Calhoun stutter steps, dances, breaks it across the 35, keeps the knees churning down at the 31 in the grasp of Casey Clark.
Much of that play was was Calhoun himself and his athletic ability. He started, they got a little crease for him to run in. Then Thornton and Kennedy, Thornton's block on Kennedy was certainly key to springing him. And as he broke up field, he jumped back inside for a very fine game.
Thornton, number nine, is really quite an athlete. He's a sophomore, 6'3", 215. We've showed you a couple of isolations on great blocks by Jim Thornton. He's converted to tight end from quarterback. And we will see him throw the ball before this football game is over. First and 10, Fullerton State. Batted down at the line of scrimmage. And the man that got the arms up, 6'3", 219, Sam Kennedy, number 55. Who has been very active, but then he led the Spartans in tackles last year with 55.
Number 23 pitch ran a little flat route that time, was wide open. The ball, of course, was tipped, so it didn't make any difference. But that has worked extremely well for them. When they get double slot showed motion, they have had receivers with no one around them most of the night.
Third and 10. You think we might see Thornton, the tight end, throw the ball? When will Gene Murphy pull that play out?
Well, Thornton's in there, so that potential may very well. All their gimmick plays have worked extremely well this far.
They need 10 for the first down. Backpedaling, Kevin Jan. Good protection, unloads wide open and incomplete at the 25-yard line was Todd White, number 21.
White ran an excellent out route, was just wide open, and a ball was overthrown.
Watch the move he puts on the cornerback.
At the top of the screen, we can see 21 getting the plant now as he drives off. There is no defender within 15 yards, and the ball slightly overthrown.
Slightly.
The only one that we saw in the area at all was a DB coming from underneath.
Kareem Abdul-Jabbar would have jumped for that.
Kareem would have made that play.
They still need 10 yards. Rolling to the right, Kevin Jan. Lots of protection. Nobody open underneath. And Sam Kennedy comes up with a hit. Interesting pass pattern for a wide open team. Fullerton State, that time, Miles, only had two wide receivers out. Kevin Jan wanted to go all the way to Wade Lockett. He was covered one-on-one, and nobody was underneath safety valve.
Well, they had a little flat route out in the flat, and it was also covered. They had two wide receivers up on top. They were both covered. The flat route was covered. And it looked as though Kevin just continued to hold the ball, continued to hold the ball, and finally ran into a blue shirt.
Len Stranley, who has kicked a 52-yard field goal, will try one here. The spot will be from the 37-yard line. They've got a fake. Todd White, who's already thrown, chased out, and the ball is batted loose. A good defensive play again by number 55, Sam Kennedy, and it brings the home crowd to life.
They try to run a kicker on a fake up the middle, and by the time he got open, and he was open, there was so much pressure that there was no chance of throwing a football. Here you can see the kicker going up the middle. He opens up, but by that time, the pressure was so great that there was no chance of throwing the football.
Watch Len Stranley, number four now. Let's see how wide open he is.
As soon as he avoids that man, now he's wide open. You can see the DBs turn to the outside.
But just that hit by 74, Mark Dean, delayed it enough so Todd White couldn't find it. First and 10 for the Spartans. Blitz is on. Carlson unloads. They've got it set up well. Mike Meredith. And a good defensive reaction by Mark Collins.
Once again, the corner's rolled up, and Fullerton has been rolling the corner a considerable amount, and it seems as though every time that they have run the screen, they've had the corner rolled up, and they've played into the screen very well.
Gene Murphy, his Titans, an upset. The Spartans were about a touchdown favorite, 14-2. Fullerton stayed on top. Slot formation to the left. In motion. There goes Carlson. Dumps it off. Got his man, Randy Walker, and a great defensive play. You talk about staying at home. Number five met number five. Collins, say hello to Walker.
Yes. Now, they drove two receivers deep, and then the first blue shirt, number five, Randy Walker, comes out in the flat. Now Collins comes off, rolls up again, and makes an excellent defensive play. Should have had some under help for Collins to keep the play to less of a gain than that. Good job by the quarterback, Allen.
Fake bootleg. Carlson in trouble. Dances. Needs a block. Needs a bunch of blocks then. Ted Hinton with a big hit, dropping Carlson for a loss.
Doug Allen, the quarterback now, is certainly bouncing around and doing a fine job of showing his athletic ability. They use him a little different than they do Carlson. They do more boots and play action fakes and roll him out, and he showed excellent athletic ability that time to get caught for a 2-yard loss.
Sam Kennedy over on the sideline. It's second down and 13 yards to go. Slotted out to the right side. Number 87. That is Sean Harvey and Kenny Nash. Doug Allen bends in. Fires. Got his man inside the 50. And he dives close to first down yardage. Kenny Nash. Two freight trains collided there.
Michael Session really put a hit. Number 57, Williams, a linebacker right at the end of the play. That was a shot thrown by Allen. Very, very fine throw to number 89, Nash. And just threaded the needle. Threw it like a dart. Michael Session was late, a bit late coming in on that hit on Williams, and Williams is now down.
Also down is number 90, Sean Foy. Foy, the junior, who's majoring in graphic design, the co-captain of the Titans, and he, of course, is the man that knocked John Carlson out of the game for San Jose State with that forearm to the windpipe. So this has been an extremely physical game. We knew it was going to be wide open. There is Foy, number 90, already on the ground. And it looks like he gets almost hit in the head.
I think here's where he's going to get it, right there. By his own man.
Fifth, 55, Carlos Adley.
Adley really runs around, got extreme speed, and he's really hustling the ball. And Sean was just starting to get up, and his own man really had a collision with him. I tell you, both these football teams are flying around and throwing their bodies around with reckless abandon. Looks like Sean is fine. I'm sure he just got dazed, and I would bet that he'll be back in there in a short period of time.
Mouse, let's go to the intensity of this game. Because it's a league game, the first league game, the preseason is over for both these two schools. Added intensity, added incentive?
I think there's the added incentive is great. It's a must win. And Cal State Fullerton, to get back to their form, it's a must win for them. So we see great intensity. and especially on the defensive side of the ball, flying around.
Walker and Meredith, the running backs on third and one for the Spartans. A quick hitter, slow in developing, though, Randy Walker. He was supposed to look like the old Pittsburgh Steeler trap block that just never developed.
Well, I'd say Adley, once again, made a very fine play. Carlos Adley, number 55, is really running around, and he was in the Spartan backfield immediately after the snap, made a big defensive play.
Well, timeout on the field with 2:48 left to go, and it's decision time for Claude Gilbert. Now, yesterday at the Spartans practice, Claude was telling us he needs to motivate his defense. He needs to find a leader and get someone out there to be a rah-rah take-charge guy, and he was searching, admittedly, for a way to get the defense fired up. Now he's got a decision to make on the offense. If he elects to not go for it here, what does that do emotionally to your team?
I think that he will definitely go for it. It's a short yardage situation where they're down 14-2. They must continue to try to get momentum. They have not yet swung the momentum to the blue shirts, and I'm sure that Mr. Claude Gilbert will be excited about juicing them up right here on offense to get the thing done.
Well, a couple of surprises in the American League. The Tigers have beaten Toronto now 2-0. That's a final. And the Yankees with that 3-0 lead against the Brewers. So if those scores hold up, the Yankees will pick up a full game and it will be only 3 games out. They began the night 4 games behind the Blue Jays. Sean Foy being attended to over on the sideline. We're also, of course, charting the Mets game against the St. Louis Cardinals for you. The New York Mets, 1 game behind the St. Louis Cardinals. Mets have taken 2 in a row from St. Louis and could leave Busch Stadium tonight dead even.
Let's see what Terry Shea calls, the offensive coordinator from San Jose Spartans. Flanks wide slot.
Doug Allen, the left-handed quarterback. Backs are split, Meredith and Walker. Quarterback dive, and I think Doug Allen had enough of a surge from David Diaz Infantati. Watch the left guard, number 63, Diaz Infantati.
And watch the speed of number 4, Allen. He really spurts and does an excellent job of getting the first down. There's no question, number 4's mind, he was going to get it done. He looked like he was shot out of a starting block when he accepted the football.
I'll tell you, Ralph Mole, our director, is hot tonight on those replays. Huh?
He's right on.
2:40 and counting in this first half. 14-2 Titans, but the Spartans are driving. First and 10, San Jose State. Play action fake, the bootleg. And Doug Allen, trying to get out of the grasp, does not. A one-arm jersey tackle by number 51. That is Jim Bioa out of Riverside, California. A junior, 6'1", 240. He bench presses 390, so it's no surprise he can hold on to Doug Allen.
And I tell you again, Carlos Adley was coming outside. Both Bioa and Adley have shown a tremendous pass rush in this series. Great quickness by those two young men.
Second and 16 after the loss of 6. Allen, airborne, safety valve, Walker. Not much doing, dives to the 49. Fullerton State's defense, boy, you can't say enough, much maligned.
I tell you, number 84 again, Hinton, who has made a great number of plays in this first half, reacted just as you'd like to have a linebacker react, came up and made the play at the line of scrimmage. Just an excellent job again by Hinton.
Doug Allen goes over and confers with head coach Claude Gilbert on the sideline with 1:45 left to go in this first half. It's third and 15 for the Spartans. They trail by 12, 14-2 for the Titans. Coming up at halftime, a feature on Eddie Robinson. We told you of the great rambling coach. We'll have a feature at halftime and an update on the pennant races. There is one of the nicest young men you'll ever meet. Russ Mayberry. I'll tell you what, though. Mr. Goodwrench has fixed that body, hasn't he?
I'll tell you what, the whole linebacker core has taken a pretty good lick as far as the San Jose, or excuse me, the Cal State Fullerton Titans are concerned. That young man with the kind of attitude he's got will probably be back next week.
You know, he was a tight end. He was a tight end for a long time before they switched him over to defense, and they found out he was hard of hearing. He couldn't hear the signals. Well, on third and 15, Doug Allen has conferred. Coming Throwing out wide to the right side is Kenny Nash. Stephen Crawford slotted out to the right. Baxter Meredith and Randy Walker. They fake the draw. Allen needs a bunch. Fires it on a rope. Got his man. First down at the 26. Kenny Nash comes up with a sliding, diving catch, and a key catch it is.
At that time, Fullerton again rolled both corners. They had two safeties, and so there's a big hole down the middle. I really think that the quarterback did an excellent job of seeing the hole. There was a man deep that he could have also thrown the ball to.
First and 10 for the Spartans from the 26 of the Titans. Motion across. On a rope. Kenny Nash with a diving catch near the 15 again. James Howard beaten on the coverage, and all of a sudden, Doug Allen and Kenny Nash are conducting a clinic.
I tell you, Doug Allen, since he's come in, he's had a couple of balls dropped, but he's been throwing the ball on the money, been throwing it tough, and Nash has suddenly come into his own as a wide receiver.
Stephen Crawford, number 22, checks in. Brings the play from that man, Claude Gilbert. Line of scrimmage, the 16-yard line. Second and a short one, almost a free play. Allen, airborne. Looks in the corner of the end zone, and it is incomplete. Boy, he had number 22 on a crossing pad, and that's where I thought he threw the ball.
Looked from here, looked like he did have that route open. He had good coverage on the man that he threw the football to. He did get into the end zone. Now we're under a minute. We can put the ball into the end zone again, or we can make the first down, stop the clock, and go from there.
Got to make the first down to keep possession. Play action fake. Allen needs a yard. The ball is batted loose and almost intercepted. What do you think of the call on third and one?
Surprised me. I tell you, Collins made a great diving catch. They boot Allen back of the fake here. Now we can see Allen coming outside. Got pretty good protection. Has a man wide open. Throws into the coverage. And now it's fourth down. About a foot to go. We got to keep this alive. You think that number four will goose it again?
Randy Walker, Mike Meredith, the running backs, along with Keith Tatum, the fullback. They still need a yard. A badly thrown ball. And Mike Meredith has it thrown behind him. Now, Allen faked the handoff into the line to Keith Tatum, the fullback, then tried to option it out to Walker.
Got a flag down.
And there's a penalty flag to be checked out. If it's against Fullerton State, it could be enough for a first down.
That time, San Jose got in their wishbone look, which they use on short yardage situations.
We have an illegal substitution by the defense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Well, there's a killer.
Well, Fullerton State is going to end the first half as they began, with mistakes. They had the football back after two rather strange calls by San Jose State.
I'll tell you what, that's one of those that you have nightmares over.
There is John Carlson. His windpipe wrapped up in ice. So instead of being first and 10 for the Titans, where they could run out the clock, it's first and 10 at the 11-yard line for the Spartans. They trail by 12. Corner incomplete. Out of the end zone. You know, Allen has shown a very nice touch. Mouse, you talked, he's been connecting with Kenny Nash and throwing it on a rope. There he lofted the ball, so he has a fine feel for the football.
Once again, they were in their wishbone look. They just had the single receiver, Nash, out wide to the left. And he just dropped two steps and laid it up on top, and it was just out of the end zone. As you say, it's a fine touch and a fine reception, but out of the end zone.
Second and 10. Allen got his man. Touchdown, Spartan. Who do you suppose it is? Kenny Nash.
The fine catch, and once again, a frozen rope. He just ran a slant pattern. Howard rolled the corner, and he hit the crease immediately in back of him.
Well, the illegal defensive substitution cost the Titans 7. They could have taken a 14-2 lead into the locker room. Now it'll be 14-8 or 14-9.
with a great deal more momentum than what they're going to end up with coming out of this one.
Doug Allen will hold. Tony Brown will boom it through, and it is good. So all of a sudden, a 14-2 game has turned around to just a 5-point deficit. Watch Kenny Nash, 89. End zone look at Doug Allen.
Now you can see 89 just going to come right inside of number two. And he makes an excellent catch wide open on the slant route inside.
Take another look, and let me ask you a question. Marcus McDade stands there, and he's a fan. He's watching the play. He's got to be making a move to the man.
He was a man. You can see him right here now. He squats, rolls up, tries to get a jam, breaks. Doesn't get a hit on the man.
Says, look, that's a good, that's a
nice. There's also got to be some help coming inside for that man.
29 seconds left to go in this first half. And so that substitution penalty cost the Titans 7 points. If you were Claude Gilbert, coach, would you have an onside kick right now?
I would kick the thing low and hard into a hole away from 44 and 28.
But you wouldn't onside kick it?
I wouldn't onside kick it.
Why not?
Because they're in a prevent defense with 9 bodies up front. I would kick it over the top.
Tony Brown sends it high, and Rick Calhoun will field it at the 6. The wall is set up, and the wall closes down. Now we've got some late hitting going on. This has been a very emotional first half. And coming up at halftime, that feature on Eddie Robinson, the outstanding coach at Grambling. A pennant update for you. Yankees were winning. Toronto has lost. George Grand will have an update on that game. Also the Mets and the Cardinals. And Kevin Jan goes back in. Now, you're Gene Murphy. You've got 24 seconds left to go. You've got a 5-point lead. Do you air it out, or do you go into the locker room leading by 5?
Well, the way San Jose's walked off, I'm sure that they'll run something very conservative. That's been their approach here anyway. San Jose's in a deep prevent defense. Now they'll hand the ball to the tailback and run it up into the middle.
Calhoun dances across the 25, and barring a penalty, that should be the final play of half number one. The half began with Reddick, Corn Reddick, fielding a punt at the 5-yard line, and he did a little disco dance backwards, was trapped in the end zone for a safety, and the score was 2-0 in favor of San Jose State. But Corn Reddick atoned quite quickly. He figured in the next 2 scores. He was on the receiving end of a 60-yard scoring strike from Todd White on the halfback option. That made it 7-2. Reddick caught one 35 yards from Jan, 14-2, and then Kenny Nash 11 yards from Allen. 14-9, our score at halftime. And now let's go to Bristol and George Grand.
Thank you very much, Jim. We'll be getting back to the field for more commentary on what transpired in this first half of football. And still to come on this College Football 85 halftime, we'll be taking a look at not only highlights of the first half of this encounter, but we'll also be taking a look at the great race for Bear Bryant's record. Of course, Eddie Robinson tied it this past week. He'll go to set it outright this coming weekend. We'll, of course, be having reports on that Saturday night during the course of our live broadcast of Auburn and Mississippi. We'll have a preview of that one as well. We are at halftime with Fullerton State leading San Jose State by a score of 14-9. Now let's go to Bob Lee in Studio B with a look at all the baseball. Bob.
Thank you, George. And what baseball it is. It looks at this hour like California Angels are going to be leaving Kansas City a game behind now in the American League West, as the Royals now late in this game, with the two leaders going into tonight deadlocked at the top of the standings of the AL West, now into the 8th inning, and Kansas City holding to a 4-0 lead. They've just now gone to the top of the 9th inning. White with a homer in this game. Balboni, number 36, with a dinger. George Brett has dialed 8, so Kansas City firmly in control of this. It looks like KC, as we go to the final series of the weekend, each team 3 games to go, will have a 1-game lead. Meanwhile tonight, Detroit. Well, the Toronto Blue Jays could have clinched tonight if the Yankees had lost. They haven't. If the Jays had won, they didn't win, because the Tigers, behind a masterful performance by Walt Terrell, with a 2-0 victory at Tiger Stadium. Blue Jays could not hit Walt Terrell all evening long. They couldn't hit his pitches. And they came darn close, or Garth Orge did, of hitting Walt Terrell with a baseball bat. Terrell was not amused, and he got back at Orge on the very next pitch. See, it punches him out of there. Scoreless game until we go to the last of the 5th inning. Tigers have runners first and second. There are 2 away. That's a Tom Brookins liner past Jesse Barfield. Nelson Simmons scoring easily. Alan Trammell comes in. Brookins gets himself a triple. He is safe at third. The only runs of the game. The Tigers up 2-0 after five. Terrell, a little trouble in the ninth inning, but with a runner on first. Chet Lemon will run this Ernie Witt drive down in center field. That ends the ball game, and the Tigers are playing the role of spoiler. They win it 2-0. The Jays' magic number still at 2. Toronto and the Yankees play 3 against each other this weekend. The Yankees were winners 3-0. Ron Guidry, 7 strong innings. Ricky Henderson led off the bottom of the first inning with a homer. And Brian Daly came on, did a nice job in relief. 3-0, the Yankees and the Jays now play in Toronto this weekend. It may come down to the makeup games. It'll be played on Monday. Boston playing 2 in Baltimore, 6-2. The Red Sox win the first one. Tony Armas with his 23rd homer of the season. And the nightcap of that twin bill now is into the seventh, where the Red Sox go for the sweep. Homers by Dwight Evans, Bill Buckner, and Larry Sheets in that game. Also on the AL schedule tonight, Seattle and Chicago. M's are up 5-3 now, bottom of the eighth. Spike Owen, home run number 6 of the season in that game. That's a quick look at the American League. We'll be updating you throughout the evening on the KC California game. That's close to a final. Next up, though, National League.
It started as most wars do, with a minor incident.
Coke, Pepsi.
And today has escalated into the sheer silliness known as the Cola Wars.
Coke is better. Pepsi's better.
Why all the fuss? Especially when there's the crisp, refreshing taste of 7-Up. You see, there's no cola like the un-cola. 7-Up, the un-cola.
Ah. United States.
Chicago, Los Angeles, Boston, Massachusetts.
United Airlines can take you to the Far East from more U.S. cities than any other airline.
New York.
United Airlines to Tokyo and to Hong Kong. Fly a friend to the Far East.
You're not just flying.
Meili.
Colila, Ohio.
You're flying the friendly skies.
I'm 32 years old. And I love Kellogg's Frosted Flakes.
Brave adults are coming forward to challenge the notion that Frosted Flakes is just a kid's cereal.
I know there's a tiger in the box. I like the taste, okay?
Because you loved them as a kid doesn't mean you can't love them as an adult.
One day, our neighbor saw the package on the table.
And we don't even have children.
With that extra crunch in milk, that frosting just right, that taste is great as ever.
Well, they've always been my favorite. So dig in. Frosted Flakes have the taste adults have grown to love. They're great!
Sit back and relax with the king of cigars, King Edward Cigars. Smoke 'em.
Saturday night, Mighty Mississippi meets Auburn in ESPN's exclusive live CFA matchup. It's your chance to see Bo Jackson in action. He's the nation's leading rusher and frontrunner for the coveted Heisman Trophy. Television's best collegiate football is on ESPN, live Saturday.
In the National League, if the Cardinals beat the Mets tonight, they will clinch at least a tie for the leadership and tie for the divisional championship in the NL East. And it may come down to that right now. Cardinals may salvage this final game of the series. They now lead it 4-2 in the top of the seventh inning. Rick Aguilera and Danny Cox, the pitchers in this game. And the Mets come home. The St. Louis Cardinals then close out against the Cubs. The Mets close out against the Expos. Phil's in the Expos tonight. 8-7 Philly victory. All 8 runs in the top of the third inning, highlighted by a Mike Schmidt 3-run homer in that affair. Padres beat the Reds today, 9-4 afternoon game. Tony Gwynn, a 2-run homer. Carmelo Martinez knocked in 4 runs in that game. And in San Francisco, 1,427 people took the BART out to Candlestick to watch a 7-2 Houston victory. Alan Ashby had 3 hits in that game. And the Cubs closed their home season with a 13-5 victory over the Pirates, coming back from a 5-1 deficit. The wind, yes, was blowing out. Major League Baseball umpires are talking about the possibility of once again, for the second time in 2 years, striking postseason games, the Major League Championship League Series, the league playoffs, because of the fact that baseball has now gone to a best-of-7 format in those series. Richie Phillips, the head of the umpires union, says he's had conversations with the presidents of both leagues. He's slightly encouraged. He sees a chance for settlement, but he's still holding out the threat of a strike. NBA news today, L.A. Clippers signed their leading draft pick, Benoit Benjamin, the 7-foot junior center out of Creighton. And in Detroit, the Pistons, who recently signed Spencer Haywood, who had been on a 2-year sabbatical from the NBA, released him today, as well as DePaul rookie guard Kenny Patterson. We're at halftime in a wild game in San Jose. We'll continue at halftime. More from George Grant right after this word.
Today, people are discovering the difference between living and living well. Well, for all those people, the menu introduces ham steak with chunky pineapple glaze, French cut green beans, and Duchess sweet potatoes. Le Menu Dinner. Because living well is still the best revenge.
Ace Best Buys.
I wonder who he is today.
Good evening.
Hi. Protect your home with the Family Guard smoke detector. The $2 rebate means it costs just $4.88.
Hello, Danny.
Hello. Your actual cost for this firefighter is just $4.88 with the exclusive Ace $5 rebate coupon.
The Ames Green Sweeper Lawn Rake.
Green is nice.
And at $3.66, a nicely priced October Best Buy.
That's the way it is. Ace says the price
with the helpful hardware man.
Yay!
Brighten your colors, sharpen your sound with high-tech components designed to astound. Fine-tune your life with Emerson. Amazing new features, the ultimate prize. Step into the future, we'll open your eyes. Fine-tune your life. Emerson feels so right.
Emerson, fine-tune your life with Emerson. Emerson.
This fuzz for everyone in uniform who keeps things running smooth.
This fuzz for you. You know America takes pride in what you do.
Budweiser salutes all the men and women who have proudly served this great country.
For all you do, this fuzz for you.
George Graham back with College Football 85. We're at halftime with Fullerton State leading San Jose State by a score of 14-9, thanks to Corn Reddick's heroics during the course of the first half. We'll be showing you highlights of that coming up in just a few minutes. We want to remind you, we've got a big Saturday of college football coming your way on ESPN, a CFA broadcast. It'll be Auburn with Bo Jackson going up against Mississippi. We'll have that live at 7:30 Eastern time. And in addition, a special bonus for you during the course of the evening, we'll be keeping you up to date on Eddie Robinson. And when we talk of Eddie Robinson, we're talking about a major milestone in the course of college football. Robinson, of course, is the man who last week tied Bear Bryant for the all-time record of collegiate coaching victories with 323. Against Prairie View this week, he'll be going for 324, and we'll be updating that story throughout the course of our live broadcast of CFA football. This past week against Oregon State, it was the defense and the offense that gelled together to give them the victory. Robinson knew it was coming.
We were extremely high for Oregon State, and we kept it under control. And just before the ball game, they actually expressed their feeling, and then they did it on the field. I think you always have to remind them, keep them reminded this week, that any time a team puts 11 people out there, that they can beat you. And when they have outstanding talent like Prairie View, it's just a matter that maybe in the other ball games last year, they hadn't worked together long enough, but they've been together long enough, and they almost showed it Saturday against Southern. I just hope that wherever I should end up, that I know that somebody in the future gonna come along and do an outstanding job and top that. This is what's got to happen, because you want football to go on and you want better coaching down the line, and they really got some fine young coaches in the country today.
Certainly the Bear was a legend in his time, and Eddie Robinson has been every much the same kind of legend during the course of his coaching tenure. And we'll, of course, be with him on Saturday night to keep you abreast of his race for a brand new record. Don't forget, in November, you'll get a chance to see Grambling live on ESPN on our Thursday night college football. We'll be taking a look at a preview of this coming Saturday's matchup between Auburn and Mississippi, and have halftime highlights. We are at halftime with Fullerton State leading San Jose State 14-9. We'll be back with more of College Football 85 after this.
Take a look at Jerry Goodwin Dodge. We're offering your choice of 7.5% financing or up to $1,500 rebates on 1985 Dodge cars. And we've got vans and van conversions for your every need. If not, we'll build to suit you. Used cars? We've got the best in Orange County with one-year free warranties to prove it. We've got finance specialists to help with credit problems and a super service department to back everything we sell, new and used. That's Jerry Goodwin Dodge, Fullerton, 91 Freeway at Euclid.
I'm a peaceful man. I wouldn't hurt a fly. But now I'm going to get out of line. I'm going to sign up for direct deposit, so I'll never have to stand in line with my government check again. With direct deposit, my money goes directly to my account automatically. That frees up my time for other things. Like my experiments.
Get direct deposit wherever you have your checking or savings account.
Oh, come on. Get out of line.
We're at halftime of our Thursday night college football encounter between Fullerton State and San Jose State. It's a five-point lead for Fullerton State. We'll be showing you highlights Eastern time on Saturday. When Mississippi goes up against Auburn, they know fully well that they're going up against one of the finer teams in the nation. Even though they were upset this past week, the folks in Mississippi know that Bo Jackson and company are going to be difficult to stop. Make no mistake about it. At Ole Miss, they know it's a big weekend.
Auburn has great talent throughout their squad. And offensively, you know, Bo Jackson's in a class by himself. And then Brent Fullwood is can probably start from for any other football team in Southeastern Conference. They had great size. There appears to us that they're still running a wishbone philosophy up front, which is a power-type football. And they like that. They're going to control the line of scrimmage. They want to control the game, and by controlling the ball.
I think it's important to the whole team, you know, not just me individually. It's our first SEC ball game to begin with, and we need to start off strong in the conference. And I think right now this is probably a pivotal point in our season after the first four games, you know, starting off in the SEC competition.
If there's a Heisman Trophy favorite this year, it has to be Bo Jackson of Auburn. They've moved to the I formation. He's even more dangerous than he was a year ago. Clearly, he's the key to their offense.
We're looking forward to do what we didn't do against Tennessee Saturday, and that's to go out and to establish our game plan before they can and put points on the board before they do.
Well, Ole Miss is a talented football team, number one. They've got a fifth-year senior quarterback in Ken Austin. They've got a good, solid offensive line. We've got excellent running backs that do a great job of catching the football coming out of the backfield. They're like all the teams around the country. They've got talented receivers. We expect them to give us a lot of problems on defense Saturday. And it's nothing out there that's going to be easy. They've got a great kicking game. They've blocked three punts. I think their punter is second to Lewis Cobert, our kid, in the SEC in punting. As I mentioned, Ambrose is a kick returner, so they're very dangerous in all phases of the kicking game. So Ole Miss is a football team, as I see them, that'll be capable of beating anybody they play any Saturday that they play.
And this is the Saturday we're concerned with. It's coming Saturday, 7:30 Eastern Time, live CFA football. It's Mississippi against Auburn. Incidentally, Mississippi has not beaten Auburn in an SEC game. They've played outside the SEC, but they haven't beaten Auburn in an SEC game since 1952 when they won it 20-7. Don't forget, we'll also update the Eddie Robinson story on Saturday night. And when we return, we'll have highlights of Fullerton State and San Jose State at halftime.
If you're looking for excitement, Anaheim Toyota Maserati has just what you're looking for. Come in and test drive the new Maserati Bi-Turbo and compare its value against any other sports coupe on the road today. Boasting the driving force of a twin-turbocharged 185-horsepower engine, this Eurosport also features luxurious leather interior, air conditioning, a technically pure sound system, and more, all standard and all for just $24,999. Anaheim Toyota Maserati, Anaheim Boulevard, off the 5 Freeway, left at Cerritos. Come share the excitement.
Showtime's exclusive excitement brings you the best in original programming in October. Be there for the premiere of our original miniseries, Tender is the Night. With an all-star cast, it's a new version of the Scott Fitzgerald classic story of wasted youth. Witness the disrobing of the Emperor in Fairy Tale Theater's The Emperor's New Clothes. Experience the fear of a family threatened by violence in Firstborn, a movie you won't see on HBO or Cinemax, in October on Showtime.
We make excitement!
We're at halftime of our Thursday night college football activity with Fullerton State holding a 14-9 lead over San Jose State at halftime, thanks to a fellow named Corn Reddick. And when you look at the first half highlights, you'll see it did not start as if Corn was going to have that great of a day, because the first 2 points that went on the board, he put them there, but not for Fullerton State. First quarter, Doug Allen to punt for San Jose State, fielded by Corn Reddick, but he's going the wrong way. He's nailed in the end zone by Brett Grouse. This safety makes it 2-0 San Jose State with the lead. Fullerton ball. Quarterback Kevin Jan pitches to Todd White. Is he running? Halfback option. White hits Reddick all alone. 41 yards worth of score. 7-2 Fullerton State. That is the sixth reception for a touchdown for Reddick. Second quarter. Fullerton on the move. Kevin Jan in trouble. Dumps it to Reddick again. Gets into the end zone with a 35-yard TD play. That made it 14-2 Fullerton State. Then San Jose State came back on a Doug Allen to Kenny Nash touchdown play. The extra point conversion was good. And we ended up with what we have at halftime, which is Fullerton State 14 and San Jose State 9. I want to remind you, we'll be back with a full ESPN Sports Center right after this college football game. Chris Berman and Greg Gumbel will be by with all the baseball scores and update you on the rest of the day in sports. And once again, on Saturday night at 7:30 Eastern Time, it's Auburn and Ole Miss and CFA football on your source for sports. And we'll, of course, be updating you on the Eddie Robinson story during the course of Saturday night's activity. Now let's go back to the field for more commentary. At halftime, Fullerton State leading San Jose State 14-9. Back to you, Jim.
Jim Kelly and Mouse Davis back with you here at San Jose State, where the Spartans are on the short end, 14-9 to the Titans of Fullerton State. Fullerton State looking for their first win, came in with a record of 0-3. And rather surprising halftime score, two big plays. And as we take a look at those first half statistics, first downs are all even up. There was a huge disparity in time of possession early on. In fact, San Jose State had the ball for 11 minutes and Fullerton State just three, but the score was 14-2. So the old adage, Mouse, it's not how long you have the ball, but it's what you do when you've got it.
I think there's no question about that, and the big play has been the difference. Big play in the kicking game, and Reddick. Reddick wore the goat horns early and then kicked them off and turned into be a good one. Now, suddenly, Doug Allen comes in the game and sparks San Jose. And they have been impressive. And now it's time to kick it up for that second half.
The first half possessions as far as San Jose is concerned. They got on the board first with a safety and led 2-0. But offensively, the punt, four plays and out. Three plays, a pass interception picked off by Tom Phillips. 10-play drive, and that was the blocked field goal. Four plays and the punt fielded by Reddick, and that was the safety. San Jose led 2-0, four plays and a fumble. Next possession, 9 plays and a punt. You don't want to have a 9-play drive and then have to punt the ball. 11 plays, you punt the ball again. And then a 15-play drive and a touchdown. And the only reason that San Jose got that touchdown, an illegal defensive substitution by the Fullerton State Titans on 4th and 1, and it gave San Jose a second chance, and they took advantage on a touchdown toss from the backup quarterback Doug Allen to Kenny Nash, the wide receiver. So Claude Gilbert's Spartans on the short end 14-9. On the other side of the ledger, Fullerton State, the Titans, 3 plays and a fumble. They started off very slowly, then a punt. Next possession, another punt. And again, we'll come back to action. Corn Reddick has the wall set up, needs a block, dances across the 25 and is out of bounds at the 26. 1st and 10 for the Titans, and there has been the big man for the whole game. He figured in 16 points, 2 for the other guys. So it's 1st and 10, and Kevin Jan, the senior quarterback out of Granada Hill, California, will come back in. And in the passing department, he was 6 out of 14, 1 touchdown, 89 yards passing in the first half. And Todd White, the halfback, 1 out of 2, but it was a big one, 60 yards to Corn Reddick for a score. Line of scrimmage, the 26, motion across by Reddick. Now the other way goes Wade Lockett. And coming at you, Bo White, the fullback. White breaks it big. First down across the 45 as he approaches midfield. Casey Clark saved the touchdown.
They're going to call holding on number 28, Calhoun. And it looked like a good block from here, but he certainly did drop the outside backer, so it may have been holding. He is the lead blocker and was really the reason that the hole opened so big for White.
Well, Fullerton State, they start off the second half as they began and ended the first half with mistakes. And from a coaching perspective now, is that discipline?
Well, that play right there may have been just from over effort. He may try to make a great block. Looked like he made a great block, but evidently hooked his hand. Okay, now if we take a look, we should see the lead block out in front. Let's see if he reaches it. You can see his arm hooked around the leg, and then it made it look much like a tackle, and he dropped Priest. Instead of Priest being the tackler, he became the tacklee.
First and 20 for the Titans. They lead 14-9. Airborne goes Kevin Jan. Another penalty flag is thrown. Jan airs it out at the 40-yard line, looking in the direction of James Pruitt. But I believe someone from Fullerton State coach jumped offside.
Just before the snap of the ball, Pruitt moved. He settled down to try to get a little more speed coming off the ball, moved, and it was illegal motion by number 20.
That's what happens, you get down in the blocks.
Right. He should have got the blocks. He was in a two-point stance, dropped to the blocks just as the ball snapped.
We have a legal motion. The 5-yard penalty against the offense has been declined. It's second down.
Second down and 20 yards to go for the Titans on the top end of a 5-point lead. Kevin Jan, the quarterback, sends Reddick out wide to the right side in the slot. Wade Lockett, number 17, and the backs are split. Bo White and Rick Calhoun. Motion by Lockett, top of your screen. Delay, Bo White. Big hole for a moment, opened up by Dave Martinez, the center out of Thousand Palms, California. Mark Stevenson, number 74, out of Ironshore, California. He's a big one, 6'3", 282. And Brett Grouse, who came up with a big play in the first half, was the man that made the hit on Bo White. How many third and 14 plays do you have?
Give it to Reddick. Reddick's coming out of the game. He definitely will not handle the ball this play.
Well, don't forget about number 9, Jim Thornton, who's the tight end, but he was a quarterback. And they've got a play where he can throw it. This time it'll be Kevin Jan. Needs 14. Right now he needs somebody to throw it to. Bumped out of bounds by Kurt Lyon, senior from Sacramento, California, who is a junior college transfer from American River College. 33 solo tackles so far. He was redshirted in 83. So it's punting time now on 4th and 18. And we'll see Jim Sirwa again, who averages about 40 yards per kick. And there's what he's done tonight. Back deep, Freddie Payton, number 21, a distant cousin, he says, of Walter Payton. In fact, there was a barbecue or something, and Freddie went to it. A few folks said, "Who are you?"
"And I'm the little one."
Fair catch is called for by Freddie Payton at the 40-yard line. So the Spartans get the ball back. They trail by 5, 13:46 to go in the third quarter.
I'm Jimmy Connors, and it's about time you met my partner, my financial side.
All successful people and companies have a financial side.
Let's go, partner.
But to really be a winning team, you might need some help.
We need some help.
You need Bain Weber behind you for financial expertise, sound advice. We believe the quality of life just might depend on the quality of your financial services.
Thank you, Bain Weber.
You're awfully stiff. You've got to loosen up a little bit.
If you're a man who wants it all, Playboy has it this fall. Football forecasts that are right on the money. Dan Jenkins' sports humor. Interviews with the top names in sports. Plus Playboy's famous mix of entertaining features, articles, and fun. Not to mention the world's most extraordinary women. For the man who wants great sports and a whole lot more, Playboy has it this fall. This month, women with genius IQs who are absolutely gorgeous. In November, Playboy on newsstands now.
Tonight's telecast between Fullerton State and San Jose State here on ESPN is brought to you by the financial professionals at Payne Webber, and by McDonald's. It's a great day for the great taste of McDonald's. Boy, seeing that blimp over Spartan Stadium, I may end up taking that blimp to Auburn. I've already missed my...
That may be the only way you're going to get there.
I said goodbye to my plane, I'll tell you that.
Been a very slow first half.
First and 10 for the Spartans. They trail by 5, 14-9. And Doug Allen in there at quarterback. John Carlson out after getting a forearm to the windpipe. Dive over the middle. Big hole. Mike Meredith up to midfield. Boy, Mike Session, number 50. And Bruce McElvain, number 75, over on the right side. Big hole.
Michael Session has really been coming off the ball. He's had several outstanding blocks and shown great hustle up the field. Number 50.
I want to talk about the quarterback, Doug Allen, too, because Carlson was 9 of 19, one interception, 101 yards. Allen got on track late, 7 of 12, 69 yards, and one touchdown. Fake dive. Allen, left-handed, throws it too far. Mike Meredith, the intended receiver. Now, Mouse, you've got the run-and-gun offense. You've got a left-handed quarterback. Toughest thing to do, roll out to the right, throw against your body.
He must really get his shoulder squared up a bit more. That's one reason he overthrew right there. He had Meredith wide open, overthrew him a bit. Meredith tried to one-hand it, trying to reach out because it was overthrown. And he had a good 8-10 yards of running room if he just dinks the ball to him. He's got to get his shoulders turned up the field so he's at the target as he throws. He had some balls dropped early, too.
Third and 2. Motion by Meredith, top of the screen. Allen, dive play. Walker, first down and a game-breaker, maybe. At the 35, loose football. It is recovered by San Jose State.
Meredith alertly jumped on the ball downfield to keep the ball for the San Jose.
Watch Walker in isolation. Big hole, and then watch Mike Romero, number 40, make the hit and force the fumble. There goes Walker. Here comes Romero. Strips him of the ball right there. But a good recovery by Stephen Crawford, the wide receiver, number 22. That's something you like to coach. Be around the football.
The blocking on that was very interesting.
Motion by Walker, bottom of the screen on first and 10. A very late developing dive play to Randy Walker. Good penetration by the defensive front, Carlos Adley and Sean Foy.
And they tried to block that much the same way, except this time Foy came very hard to the mesh point of the quarterback and the dive back. The previous play, the outside backer played soft. They had a nice hole up inside with no one touching the outside linebacker.
Second down, a long 9. Slot formation to the right side. Here comes Walker toward you. Allen can run it. Inside the 25, if he gets a block, turns the corner, and he goes out of bounds at the 25. Tom Phillips stayed in his lane. Otherwise, that was 6.
Now, as you see the play on replay, we're going to see maximum zone drops from underneath, and all of them are covered. Now, Doug Allen shows his athletic ability, just breaking outside. Walker comes back inside for one block. He beats Allen beats one man outside to turn into a nice little game.
Line of scrimmage, the 25. And as Allen looks over the defense of the Titans, he looks at 3rd and 3. Slot formation to the right side. Cage and Nash. Pitch back. Walker gets a block, turns the corner, dives close to first down yardage near the 23. Mark Collins submarined him. Let's see if we can pick up Randy Walker. Here he takes that loaf of bread and does a little dance with it.
Yeah, you know, the bare blocking is what's really making this drive go. They continue to run the bare. That time they ran the option on the outside, and Walker did a good job of getting the first down.
Well, down below us, we have been visited by Crazy George and his tom-tom. It's 1st and 10 for the Spartans on the short end of a 14-9 count. Nash in motion. Bootleg. Allen needs a block. Gets it. It's another one inside the 10. Allen to the 5. 1st and goal for the Spartans.
This whole drive has been the beer action. by Allen coming out, he gives them a much different convention than Carlson. They're running more and more beer out of the split back look, turn them loose, and now they're closing off the inside dive play, and Carlson's keeping, or excuse me, Allen's keeping the ball and turning them into big plays outside.
Watch 87 and the job he does right there on the right side of your screen on Collins. First and goal. They spotted at the 8. They say Allen went out of bounds there. Inside handoff to Meredith. Cracks it inside the 5.
And suddenly, San Jose is a split-back beer team.
You know, suddenly, I go back to the end of the first half. That costly 5-yard penalty, it could have been a 14-2 halftime lead. Fullerton State made the mistake. Doug Allen punches it in, and the momentum has definitely swung to San Jose State.
No question, and one of the big momentum swingers has been Doug Allen.
Coming out wide to the left side for the Spartans, Kenny Nash. He has a touchdown catch. He's getting one-on-one coverage by McDade. Allen. Fumble in the backfield. It looked like Allen might have gotten it back. Allen tried to hand the ball off to Randy Walker.
On the first part of the beer, the dive action of the beer, and laid it on the ground.
There's the bat exchange, but it bounces, gets a good dribble, and Allen covers it up. So it's 3rd and 4. It was 1st and goal from the 8.
The mesh point turned a little tighter inside, and Allen wasn't prepared for it. That was the reason for the fumble.
Kenny Nash wide to the left. Allen's a left-handed quarterback, should come to the left. Meredith moved in the backfield. It's an apparent touchdown that should be called back. No flags. I don't believe it. This is unbelievable.
They're not going to call anything.
Fullerton State is screaming. There were 3 San Jose players in motion.
Amazing.
And the defense just stopped. They didn't run out to play. Gene Murphy is in disbelief. He said, wait a minute. There were more people moving there than the June Taylor dancers.
It did look like we had a lot of tangos going there, didn't we?
You can have 1 man in motion, but not 3.
This is Canadian rules. We had 11 that time.
Spartans will apparently go for 2. They just got a gift of 6. Straight T backfield now with Walker, Meredith, and Crawford. Out wide to the right is Nash. Allen bends in. Bootleg to the left. Can throw a run. Walks to the end zone, and it is intercepted by Collins. In the general direction of Nash. Now let's take a look at the touchdown, and you count how many men are in motion. Gene Murphy's already counted. All right, there's 2. There's another one. Well, I saw 2 men go.
Randy Walker was almost line of scrimmage by the time the ball was snapped. The quarterback's rocking back. We had at least 3 illegal men in motion.
I don't think Gene Murphy's going to believe the explanation if we stay all night.
Thank you. Come again.
People who come to McDonald's know quality. Like classy Mary Young, who loves our quarter pounder. She would never settle for less than 100% pure all-American beef. Or Jim Taylor, he's always together.
And a Big Mac, please.
Only sear, sizzled, lean beef is good and juicy enough for him. And Kim Nelson likes pure stereo sound, and her cheeseburger has to be pure 100% beef. That's why she keeps coming back to McDonald's.
Test pilot Chuck Yeager for AC Delco.
Up here, power when you need it can save your neck. When you get back down to your car, it helps too. Today's smaller engines need extra firepower from a spark plug, and AC delivers. If you could look inside your engine, you'd see an AC spark plug delivering up to 30,000 volts, firing 30 times a second. Firepower when you need it from AC.
Get rebates now on AC spark plugs.
Never wait for trouble.
Watch the quarterback, Doug Allen, and the 2 backfield men. Allen will start to pull out before the ball is snapped. He moves,
back.
The backs move,
now
and there's the ball.
Now the ball
is just coming up.
There were only 3 people illegal in motion.
Another look. You see the ball on the ground just beyond the outstretched arms of the nose tackle. All right, there's the ball, but everybody's in motion.
Right. Already the quarterback had taken 1 full step back.
I'll tell you what. There's a disco here in San Jose called the Rodeo. There was more dancing on that play than at the rodeo.
Oh, my. Three illegal motions.
Gene Murphy cannot believe it.
For a touchdown.
He says, all right. I've got one of those plays.
I'll tell you one thing. It's done. It's given us a 15-14 fairly exciting football game. Now let's turn it into a great one.
Rick Calhoun is back deep. Tony Brown. And Calhoun comes out with it. They fake the reverse. Calhoun dances across the 20 and is hammered down at the 25-yard line. So a little razzle-dazzle from Gene Murphy, and it's first and 10 Titans. They still have 9:52 with which to work here in quarter number three. Boy, we have seen a little bit of everything.
Isn't that true? Made an exciting play out of it, didn't he?
Fumbles, interceptions, reverses, 60-yard touchdown passes, a couple of cheap shots.
Let's see what Murph's got left in the playbook.
Hood and Scott are the running backs coming out wide to the right. Lockett and Reddick. They'll command your attention. Kevin Jan gives to the fullback, Mark Hood. He churns up near the 30-yard line. And you can see the defenses, Coach, on both sides picking up the tempo a little bit. The hitting, it was ferocious in the first half, getting mean down there in the second half.
That play is a perfect example where Scott just got shoved off the block and very tough 4-yard run.
Second and 5. Spartans fake the blitz and now back off. Motion across. Allen picks. Airborne. Got him. Dropped. What goes
Short
through your mind?
Flat route and Fitz drops the ball.
What goes through your mind when you're a coach and the ball is just flat out dropped?
Usually nothing that's a real pleasant thought. One of those things that you have derogatory thoughts and then you run through. But you got to rally it back, and if you live with the pass, you're going to drop one now and then, and you believe, and I always believe, I can go right back to the receiver that dropped it, and the next time he's going to make a big play for us.
Fullerton State on third down conversions and what they've done, and Gene Murphy wants a timeout right now. Number 9 checks into the lineup. So with 9:13 left to go in the third quarter, the Spartans have taken a 1-point lead on a suspect play.
This bud's for everyone who puts the roads on the map.
This bud's for you.
Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do, yeah, for you.
Want to build a super day? Then start with the one great taste that makes a super bowl of cereal. Kellogg's Corn Flakes.
Just think of crispy golden flakes.
Delicious, crunchy flakes of corn.
So pure and simple, just can't wait.
Low in sugar, loaded with vitamins and iron.
So good for you, don't hesitate.
For a super bowl of our most nutritious corn flakes ever.
What a super bowl. Have yourself a super bowl. Kellogg's Corn Flakes. Super taste, super good. Kellogg's Corn Flakes.
His team is 0-3. They had a 14-2 lead. They made a costly penalty just before the end of the first half. It allowed the Spartans to draw within 5. San Jose State took advantage, marched right down, got a break from the part of the officials, and have taken a 1-point lead. 3rd and 5. Going out wide to the left side. Wade Lockett deployed wide to the right. Number 20, James Pruitt. In the I Pro set, the backs are Mark Hood and Rick Calhoun. Play action. Allen. Jan dives across the 30, near the 33, and a great defensive play by Wayne Woodard. Also, number 55 was in there. That's Sam Kennedy, who's had a big game.
Appeared to be run all the way. They had two receivers deep, but Kevin certainly was sprinting hard on the corner and appeared to be run all the way.
Sirwa, who's had a busy night, boosted his average by about 3 yards per kick. There is Freddie Payton, number 21. He will be the deep back. And the up back, Casey Clark, number 16. The kick is away. It is a high, high kick. It is fumbled and then gathered in by Freddie Payton. Well, the NHL is back on ESPN with an exclusive 3-year national cable contract. Your total sports network is going to deliver 33 regular season games, the NHL All-Star Game, and a full complement of Stanley Cup playoff contests as well. Be at center ice for all the high-powered scoring of the great number 99, Wayne Gretzky, Mike Bossy of the Islanders, Marcel Dion, and the rest of the NHL All-Stars. ESPN will drop the puck and bring you the hottest action on ice, live coverage of the two-time defending Stanley Cup champion Edmonton Oilers, three games involving the 80 Cup champs, the runner-up Philadelphia Flyers, the Islanders, the Capitals, plus a lot more. And our first game, the Capitals and the Rangers. It'll be the debut of Ted Sather, the new coach of the New York Rangers. I'll be there as your on-site host. Tom Meese back in the studio with scores and highlights. Dan Kelly on the play-by-play along with Sam Rosen, Mickey Redmond, Brad Park, ESPN. The hot place to be for the game on ice. 8:24 left to go in the third quarter. Spartans lead the Titans 15-14. We'll return to Spartan Stadium after this timeout.
Hello?
Yes.
Oh, is he badly hurt? Frank's been injured at work.
Call the law offices of Gilbert Carrion. They helped me when I had an industrial accident.
Accidents can happen anytime.
And remember, Mrs. Hernandez, there is no fee charged on this consultation appointment.
And if we don't win, we won't charge you. The law requires that all employers and drivers carry insurance against accidental injury. Here at the law offices of Gilbert Carrion, we are ready to help you when you need us most.
Hi, I'm Marvelous Marvin Hagler. You know, some people think that they can get paid TV without paying for it. They rig their cable boxes using legal equipment or hook into cable lines without paying. I call that stealing, and so does the law. Cable theft is a crime. So if you get caught doing it, you could be fined $1,000, you could go to jail, or both. So don't do it.
Cable theft is a crime.
Jim Kelly and Mouse Davis back with you on ESPN. There's our time left in quarter number three, and we've still got all of the fourth quarter to go. So this one is far from over. Wide to the left side, number 89 for the Spartans. That is Kenny Nash with one touchdown to his credit. Motions across, Mike Meredith. First and 10, Doug Allen, quick hitter. Randy Walker blocking over on the left side by David Diaz Infantani, 6'2", 247. Missed a little bit of last year because of a knee injury. He's quite an athlete. Lineman of the year, Central Catholic High School back in 81. 6'2", 247. How do you like your left guards?
I like him about 285 and extremely quick, very intelligent, great feet.
Give him a few of those enchiladas you put down last night.
There we go.
Second and five. Backs are split. And here comes Walker. There goes Meredith. First down into Titan territory, Tom Phillips and Mike Romero. And watch the blocking develop.
All right, if we get a look now on number 90, we're going to see him come upfield. The block's going to develop inside of number 90. They will not touch number 90. He runs inside off that beer-type block and a big hole up the field. They've turned certainly to the beer action for moving the football.
First and 10 for the Spartans from the 47-yard line of Fullerton State. That's Walker going to the top of the screen. Doug Allen bends in. A little delay to Meredith. He's got some room if he turns the corner. Nice move inside the 45. Bumped out of bounds by the local product, Vernon Norwood, out of San Jose, California. He's quite a long jumper.
All the front of Cal State Fullerton did an excellent job of just sliding to the football, maintained good leverage on the football, and what Meredith got, he got just with athletic ability.
You know, Mouse, I like Doug Allen as a quarterback. He throws with authority, he runs with authority, and he seems to have taken command of the huddle. They just seem much crisper when they break the huddle, they get up there and...
Certainly, he's been the difference since he came into the ball game this evening.
Line of scrimmage, the 43-yard line. Second, a long six. Walker going the other way, and now the wrong way. Now, Everybody's in motion. That's their touchdown play. Here goes Allen up top. Pump fake and down at the 50-yard line in the grasp of Carlos Adley, the only incoming freshman to earn a letter last year out of Temple City, California. Watch from the end zone, number 55, the agility of Carlos Adley.
A little cross stunt, and Adley comes back inside, and just a second effort and continued desire to get the football is all it did for Adley. When we were talking to Murph yesterday, he was extremely excited about the athletic ability of Adley and believe that he may turn into one of their better pass rushers before this season's over, and he's showing that tonight.
Third and 12, airborne. Incomplete at the 42-yard line. It would not have been enough for a first down. Freddie Payton could not hang on. So the punting team comes out for the Spartans. And finally, the defense of Fullerton State, they have been very unemotional ever since that penalty, Mouse.
I tell you, they had two people, they being San Jose, had both Payton and Walker wide open. They could have hit either one. Walker may have had enough for the first down.
Corn Reddick is back deep, and to do the punting, Doug Allen. He gets away a high, wobbly kick. Reddick fields at the 10. And goes backwards and is chopped down at the 8-yard line. Saturday, October the 5th at 7:30 Eastern Time. The number one team in the nation, the Auburn Tigers, meet Mississippi. It's our live CFA Game of the Week here on ESPN, featuring Bo Jackson against one of the best defenses of the country. And, of course, for the Rebels of Mississippi, their quarterback, Kent Austin, split receiver J.R. Ambrose, placed Ole Miss in the top 10 in passing, scoring, and total offense. Should be quite a game. Paul McGuire's there now. I'll be taking that Payne Weber blimp or air balloon.
We'll try to get that thing down just before the game's over.
I'm not getting in there. Here comes Calhoun, and he could break it. One man stopped him. Larry Weldon was a bucking Bronco on the backside. Otherwise, he was gone. Watch 74, the junior, 6'3", 284, Mark Stevenson and the blocking he does. Watch him hold his block here, Coach.
And watch the lead block by Titsworth coming around the outside. Now, great feet staying on with Stevenson. And we're not going to see the rest of the action, but two good blocks by both 64 and 74.
Looked like a railroad freight car coming at you. There goes Bo White the other way. Marcus McDade submarine Bo White and went down low. 5:45 and counting in the third quarter. 15-14. San Jose State on the top end. How about the defense, Coach? You've San Jose State. It was something that concerned Claude Gilbert all week. He's still looking for the leader, someone to emerge, and he just doesn't think the defense as a unit has been very aggressive.
And I think that they've still not found really their leader. They're playing with a great deal more emotion, a great deal more consistency. Since Allen came into the ball game, they begin to take a little more control up front. From an offensive standpoint of moving Cal Fullerton off the ball, defensive, they're flying to the ball well, and really Fullerton has not pushed him with the passing game like they did when they had the football moving in that second quarter. I would look for Cal State Fullerton to come back with more of the pass game, more movement, more receivers in the game, and fewer people in the backfield.
Second down and 5 for the Titans on the short end, 15-14. The injured player, Wayne Woodard, went off under his own power. Baxter split. Bernice Scott checks in now. A little misdirection play to Scott, and Scott has got some blockers. Across the 35, chops his way up to about the 37-yard line in the grasp of number 50, the senior from Tustin, California, Jim Hollinger.
Good job by Cal State Fullerton coming off up front. As we look at the misdirection and see once again, Tetsworth pulling, leading the play, and he's done a very fine job of leading on the misdirection plays, the reason that we have a nice hole. It's a good job right there on the man upfield in the secondary.
That's Hollinger, number 50. We'll come back to him in a moment. It's first and 10. There goes Bernice Scott again, and he is chopped down, and right in the middle of things is Hollinger again. Mouse, I go back to what we were talking about, the theme where Claude Gilbert's looking for a defensive leader. Jim Hollinger told me at practice yesterday, you know, he said the coach will talk to us, and it starts to sink in, And then our minds just start to wander, all of us. It's no one particular player, it's everybody.
I believe that that's pretty good analogy, and it's kind of the way this ball game has gone. They've had great zips, and they've kind of fallen into a little lethargy, and now we've got a very tight ball game going because of that.
Dive play over the middle, and there's a quick hole for Bernes Scott. Titsworth, Martinez, Stevenson, the Hogs up front. Watch down low. You don't hear their numbers that often, but 79, Ed Gillis, 64, Darryl Titsworth, 52, Dave Martinez, and 74, Mark Stevenson.
Good job by the offensive line coming off, and then a very good job by Scott cutting in back of the blocks and away from the flow of the San Jose defense.
Third and one. What would you call here?
Third one, I would call a play. We're for sure going to make a first down.
Bernes gets the call. Dives across the 45 up near the 48-yard line. And that's a first down for the Titans.
And the Titans are getting good movement up front. The thing that we're talking about with San Jose now, they are losing just a little bit of their zing on defense. And by the same token, Cal State Fullerton is picking it up and getting good movement off the ball, getting good running lanes.
3:35 and counting in quarter number three. First and 10, Fullerton State, their 0-3 coming in, looking for their first win. And of course, this, everybody's first PCAA game. A dive play by Calhoun, slow and developing, and Hollinger right in the middle of things. Maybe he'll emerge as the defensive leader.
Possibly. I tell you, Cal State, Fullerton is doing a great job of either Stevenson or Titsworth leading. That time Stevenson was a blocker that pulled out, had a good crease, and they're 3, 4, and 5 yarding San Jose to death right now.
And Mouse, as they do that, 3, 4, and 5 yarding, what's happened to the coaching philosophy? Both coaches really have gone to the ground game after moving up and down the field by the air.
It's about time now for Cal State to pull one out of the hat.
Well, here he goes. Kevin Jan, and a great reception, first and goal at the 9. Wade Lockett on the catch. A rainmaker from Kevin Jan, and Lockett with outstanding concentration.
I think that's a little bit their philosophy. What they're doing is they're kind of lulling them to sleep. About midfield, you can look for Fullerton now to start pulling the plug and make a big play happen. Very fine job by Lockett, staying on a football and making a catch. Excellent job.
How about that, though? He's making the catch. Here's Lockett. Now, the ball is thrown to the opposite side. He's catching it over his left shoulder while he's falling away from the football. Maybe the toughest catch to make.
That's where you'd like to throw the ball, faded away from the receiver, and a fine job by Lockett.
There goes Calhoun. Excuse me, that is Bo White, and a penalty flag is down.
And out comes the yellow flag.
Well, it'll either be holding or a face mask.
The way Fullerton's walking back, it looks like may be the first.
Holding, offensive line. Mark Stevenson checks out. Larry Waldo, 61, out of Bakersfield, California, checks back in. Waldo had a shoulder problem last year. He might get it in the weight room. He bench presses 345.
I tell you, Stevenson has done a very good job. They weren't particularly satisfied with him on that last play, but he's done a good job in this
drive. 10-yard penalty, still.
Well, instead of being second and goal from the 9, it's first and goal from the 19. There's Gene Murphy looking for his first win this year. Todd White checks in at wide receiver. Now, he can throw the ball. He's at the bottom of your screen. Top of the screen is Lockett. Fake. Inside, up top goes Allen, and that is a touchdown. Lockett. Stacy Gilchrist back there on the coverage, number 17, beaten by Wade Lockett, also number 17.
And a fine throw by Kevin Jan, and that tell you that was right on the money, and an excellent job of concentrating by the wide receiver.
You know, in talking with Kevin yesterday at practice, he says he's an intermediate range thrower. His accuracy is about 35 yards. Well, those last two passes from to Lockett have been much further than that and right on target.
That was a great pass, just where you had to throw it, and fine job by Lockett, just the way you'd like to draw it up.
San Jose has taken a timeout. Let's take another look while we have the timeout. Watch 17, Gilchrist on the coverage, Lockett on the reception.
Little dive action fake. Kevin Setz, fairly good heat on him by the San Jose front. Throws it outside. Nice catch. And the foot is right on the line.
Yeah, let's see that again.
I would say that that's one that is also out of bounds.
Maybe we can slow it down.
He dives it up, and his foot comes down on the line.
That was
out of bounds.
Well, that's the get-even call.
Yeah. Both
watch
teams
the left,
have now had
watch the
one.
Left foot.
It goes up in the air. He catches the ball now. The foot comes down on the line.
On the line, out of bounds, and the left foot clearly comes down out of bounds. My mom, my dad.
And they're still counting at six.
What's up, Connie?
Well, each team has been given a gift by the officials. San Jose scored when three men were in motion, and clearly that catch by Lockett was out of bounds. Fullerton now apparently will go for a two-point conversion. They have taken the timeout. Gene Murphy has sent in the play.
Certainly makes sense in this situation. 5 points difference. You'd like to get to the seven.
Calhoun the tailback, and they might have taken too much time. You don't want to do that when you're trying for a two-point conversion.
Isn't that true?
Would you still go for the two-point conversion, or would you send your kicker in now?
Well, I think you still go for the two-point because you don't gain anything in going. You do put yourself in a position where it's two field goals. That's the only difference.
Well, or a touchdown, and then you maybe block the extra point.
You have that potential.
Dead ball. Offense lined up in the neutral zone.
They lined up offside. Okay. It wasn't too much time. They lined up offside.
20-15 is the score. 1:51 left to go in the third quarter. And the Titans will go for the two-point conversion.
Same play on.
89, John Smith, the tight end. He's the man in motion. Kevin Jan throws this one out of bounds.
And had he hit Thornton, number nine, crossing to the other side, he had him wide open. His eyes went all the way to Pitts, and Thornton was wide open on the other side of the end zone.
We've got a long way to go. 1:51 left in the third, the whole fourth quarter, and it's been a wide open football game. Titans lead by 5, 20-15. We've told you about hockey. We've told you about CFA football. Well, ESPN, your Total Force in auto race coverage, continues to bring you the best live racing action on Sundays. And on Sunday, October the 5th, ESPN will travel to Laguna Speedway for Kart Stroh's 300. Al Unser Jr., the leading standings man, Al Unser Sr., right behind, and the defending points champ, Mario Andretti, is third. Emerson Fittipaldi, Danny Sullivan, the Indy 500 winner, all close behind. So watch the Kart Stroh's 300 live from Laguna Raceway.
Time for the Spartans now for their big offensive movement.
Len Stradley will spot it at the 40-yard line. Freddie Payton, Stephen Crawford are back deep. This has been an interesting debut, PCCA action as far as Fullerton State and San Jose State are concerned. It's been up and down, but neither team's really been able to take command. The Titans had it for a while, a couple of gifts. Spartans get back into it.
Keeping all the fans here.
High, but wobbly kick and short. Payton takes it at the 12. Oh, what an arm tackle at the 17-yard line. A little clothesline number. James Howard. You could feel that one up here.
Here comes Howard. Now he reaches right out with that left hand. At the same time, he gets a hit from the San Jose man, and now all the rest of the Titans arrive. Good coverage by the kickoff team. High, good hang time by the kicker.
So Doug Allen, there's what he's done since replacing John Carlson. After Carlson had his windpipe almost removed by Sean Ford. Blitz by Ford. Allen unloads, and it's batted down. Batted down by Jim Bioa out of Riverside, California. He bench presses 390 and wanted a little piece of Doug Allen.
And good pressure by Ford. Boy comes up almost clean, and then a good job by the whole front of putting their hands up, knocking the ball down. And Walker, coming underneath, was open. He had a good route that probably would have been a first down play.
You know, Mouse, Allen seems to be more effective as a quarterback, not as a drop back passer, but when he rolls or sprints out.
Very rarely do they drop. Occasionally a little three-step drop, but mostly it is boots and roll.
Second and 10, dive play, nothing doing to Mike Meredith out of Belmont, California. So far an 85, 592 yards, three touchdowns rushing, and Bioa, number 51, the nose guard, right in the center of things. You know what they say about playing nose guard, don't
what
you?
What do they say about playing nose guard?
It's like being a fire hydrant at a dog convention.
And that's true. I think some of those guys feel a little like that at times. When you're a 3-4 nose guard, you got to have a little of that fire plug in you.
You command the crowd, don't you?
Lots of centers and guards on your body.
Third and 10. A minute left in the third quarter. Allen can run for it if he chooses. Fires. Got a man open, and he misfires at midfield. Todd Cage was wide open, and Allen almost jumped past it. Showed a good arm. He threw it 35 yards on a string, but it was over the arms of that man, Todd Cage.
Both half-field safeties broke to the football, and Cage did not reach up for the ball. He knew it was way overthrown, and he did get a good lick from both safeties.
Watch 40 Romero and 44 Phillips arrive.
Ball overthrown. Right. Now, here's Phillips coming from one side, Romero from the other. That's a two-team lick, and Cage is still down.
Little Oreo sandwich there.
Right.
Fourth and 10. This has been an extremely hard-hitting football game.
Really have been some tremendous hits.
I'll tell you what, we saw Michigan State and Notre Dame a couple weeks ago, and it was nothing like this game in terms of ferocity and hitting.
They are really flying to the football. And it certainly, you can tell, it means a great deal to both football teams for the intensity they're playing with.
Allen had better be careful here. He is 3 yards away from the end zone. Horn Reddick, and if he fields it and goes forwards, not backwards, should set up the Titans in great field position. Fullerton State looks like they're coming. They are. Collins almost blocked it. Reddick will let it hit at the 45, and it is dead at the 45, maybe the 46-yard line. 47 seconds left in quarter number three. Fullerton State, 0-3, looking for their first win. Fullerton State on the short end of losses to Montana, Nevada, Reno, and Wyoming. And the San Jose State Spartans, they lost to California, beat New Mexico State, and then back-to-back losses, a blowout by Stanford, and a 35-32 heartbreak loss to Utah State. Well, we've got lots more Thursday night football for you here on ESPN. Mouse and I will be in Nevada for the Runnin' Rebels. It'll be the Runnin' Rebels taking on New Mexico State. It'll be trick-or-treat night on Halloween. Hope you'll join us that Thursday night. Kevin Jan. Little dive play to Rick Calhoun. Spartans now with that 5-point lead. A little early to go into the shell, though. You want to work on the clock a little bit, but you don't want to get too conservative, only with a 5-point lead.
And I think we're going to see. Now, we're right about midfield, and this is when Fullerton has pulled out the plugs and come out with one of the gimmick-type plays and have really made them pay off. Every time they've run any kind of different action, reverse-type pass, it's been very successful for them.
Second down and 6. Wide receivers left and right. Lockett and Pitts. Calhoun and White are the running backs. They are split. This is Bo White. Big block, turns the corner, cracks his way to the 45, turns down to the 43-yard line before Larry Weldon wrestles him down. Big block that time by 64, Darrell Titsworth, 3-year letterman out of Pomona, 6'1", 280, and Mark Stevenson, 74, the junior guard out of Elsinore, California. The two guards pulling that time and setting up a big hole for Bo White.
Picture tackle by Weldon. Great hitting position. Had a great pop into the ball packer. That's just the way you'd like to have your DBs strike that running back.
That's the end of the third quarter. The Fullerton State Titans have taken a 5-point lead against the Spartans of San Jose State. We've got 15 minutes left on a special Thursday night edition of football here on ESPN.
American Express presents Do You Know Me? A look at the lives and careers of famous athletes. This week's American Express sports personality had one of the longest careers in pro boxing. This featherweight won the world championship in 1942 and defended it for 6 years. The Will of the Wisp won 230 of 242 bouts. We'll tell you who he is after this word from American Express.
Do you know me?
Who cares?
That, of course, is Garfield. He's fat.
Full figure.
Ill-mannered, and to think I created him. But sometimes when I travel without the tubby tabby, people don't know my name, so I carry the American Express card, and wherever I go, folks treat me like a fat cat.
Fat chance.
To apply for the card, look for an application and take one.
The American Express card. Don't leave home without it.
Do you know this week's American Express sports personality? After winning the world featherweight title, he did not lose a title defense until he met Sandy Sadler in 1948. He and Sadler would trade the title several times before Sadler took it away from him for good in 1951. Still, his ring record stands as one of the most outstanding ever posted. We're talking about Willie Pep, this week's American Express sports personality.
Sometimes getting car financing turns out to be one long hassle.
What kind of car did you have in mind?
A Fiero.
Oh, an Italian car.
It's a Pontiac from General Motors.
You know, they make Chevrolets, Oldsmobiles, Buicks, Cadillacs.
GMC trucks?
This is none of my business, but those are not Italian cars.
Make it easy on yourself. Finance your car or truck right at your GM dealer with GMAC.
You understand, we do have to know what you want to do with all these cars.
Nobody knows more about financing and leasing cars than GMAC.
Jim Kelly and Mouse Davis back with you here on ESPN, a special Thursday night edition of college football, and it's been a good one in the PCAA. The Titans of Fullerton State, 0-3, looking for their first win. The Spartans of Claude Gilbert, 1-3 coming in, but they're on the short end by 5 as we begin the fourth quarter, and the Titans have the football. It's first and 10 from the 43-yard line of San Jose State. Bernice Scott, the running back, end around. There goes Thornton. Former quarterback, and he cracks it inside the 40 and is bumped out of bounds at the 36 by Kurt Lyon. Coming off with apparently a hamstring pull is James Pruitt, number 20. Of course, earlier in the football game, you saw number 82, Mark Chisholm, go down, the junior out of San Bernardino, California. And Mark Chisholm was taken to the hospital. They have x-rayed his neck. The report from the hospital is he has a slight tingling sensation in the neck. They are still checking as to the exact degree and severity of the injury. Second and 4, and Bernice Scott barrels his way inside the 35, churns on down to about the 31, where Larry Weldon wrestles him down. Watch the middle now of the offensive line for Fullerton State. Titsworth 64, Martinez 52, and Stevenson 74, coach.
Here's a good job by Titsworth Bolin and back of Martinez. And the man that really makes a play is Scott. He burst up inside. Very fine game for the first down.
Good enough for a first down in Bo White. Hood, rather. Mark Hood out of Long Beach. You know, he is a very deceptive runner. 5'11", 220, but I think, Coach, he's got great acceleration.
Each time that he has carried the football, he's done a very fine job. He certainly is not one that they rely on. Scott is more the guy for their running game, but he has been effective for them.
Second down and 6, 14-27, and there are the third quarter statistics. Time of possession, not really a factor. Fullerton State on the top end, despite the fact they've had the ball 8 minutes less than San Jose State. Counter going the other way in Calhoun, but a good defensive play by Danny Clark, the senior out of Santa Ana, California, a second-team All-American last year, bothered by injuries, 10 sacks, but that time a good defensive
play. Let's take a look at Danny, number 48, playing nose, fights himself out, spins back, sees the football flowing outside, an excellent drive to the ball. Danny is one of the better football players in the defensive front, and they're extremely excited about getting him back on a full-time basis. He certainly looked good there.
Big third down play for the San Jose State Spartan defense. Devin Jan. Safety valves it out. Burness Scott on the receiving end cuts it back against the grain and is chopped down at the 25 by Sam Kennedy. You talk about making a tackle secure. Ouch.
You know, Lyon, Kurt Lyon made a very good reaction, number 54, out to the screen, and an excellent job by Scott breaking it back inside, and as you said, fine tackle.
So we'll see the field goal kicker, Len Strandley, the junior out of Tacoma, Washington. Again, he hit one for 52 yards against Reno. He was getting an awful lot of help from Chuck Nelson of the Rams. I was talking with Len yesterday as he was kicking at practice, and he used to go down and watch the Rams work out. Chuck Nelson would work with him before and after the practices, and really said was probably the one that helped him most as far as his kicking game is concerned.
Has an extremely strong leg. Great hang time on his kickoffs.
Oh, we've got some great news, Mouse. Mark Chisholm is okay. The junior out of San Bernardino, California. X-rays turned up good. He is leaving the hospital, and he's going home to San Bernardino and will be visiting his mother.
I'm sure that everyone, best wishes go out to him, and we're certainly pleased to hear that kind of news.
That is great news. So, Mrs. Chisholm, if you're watching in San Bernardino, your son's on your way home, and he is healthy and happy, and maybe get to the refrigerator.
It's amazing how fast those young men do pop back.
Lawrence Fan, the sports information director here at San Jose State, has been charting the medical progress all night for us. Field goal try of 43 yards, hash mark to the right. Snap, spot, kick. It is on its way, and it is no good. Tough to tell from up here whether it was Len who miskicked it, because so often you've got the snapper and you've got the holder, and all three have to be in tandem. It's still a 5-point Titan lead, and the Spartans get it back.
Out here, it's me alone against the course. But in the financial world, you need all the help you can get. You need the Payne Webber Army behind you.
Even golf legends can use some financial backup. Payne Webber is ready to roll, putting all its resources at your command. We believe the quality of life just might depend on the quality of your financial services.
Thank you, Payne Webber. Now that's the kind of army you want behind you.
Now with Castrol, the motor oil engineered for smaller cars, you'll save more than wear and tear on your engine. You'll save on Prestone antifreeze, Simonized wax, STP gas treatment, Purolator filters, and more. In every 12-pack of Castrol, a rebate's worth $45. So Castrol makes things easy on your budget while it makes things easy on your engine. The Castrol money-back 12-pack.
Tonight's ESPN telecast between Fullerton State and San Jose State is brought to you by the financial professionals at Payne Webber, by Castrol, the motor oil engineered for smaller cars, and by the U.S. Armed Forces. It's a great place to start. Jim Kelly and Mouse Davis back with you here on ESPN. There's our score and our time remaining. Lots of time, and the air will be filled with football, especially with Doug Allen at the controls, the sophomore quarterback out of Los Angeles. Last player recruited last year, but he's got a great gun. Handoff goes to Mike Meredith. Jim Bio, number 51, in the center of things, along with Carlos Adley.
Once again, they're back to the Veer approach. Have consistently run the Veer approach in this second half.
Well, with this much time left, you wouldn't expect Claude Gilbert to keep it on the ground, and he's developing a young sophomore quarterback, Doug Allen. He's been throwing to Kenny Nash. He's been the main receiver. Motion across by Randy Walker, bottom of the screen on second and eight. The left-handed quarterback fires left, incomplete. The one thing Allen does not seem to be able to do is throw when his feet are not planted or firmly, when he's got that one foot up and he's off to the side, he seems to release too soon. It's almost like a baseball sailing on
him. I think he has tends to do that bit in a straight drop. When he, like, he was in a three-step drop that time, was still moving backwards, he threw the football off his boot action and the play action. He throws the ball fairly well, and he's had at least three footballs dropped this evening. Throws it with pretty good accuracy coming off the boot action.
Randy Walker, Freddie Payton, running backs now. Stephen Crawford, Todd Page in motion. Third and eight, underneath, got his man, Randy Walker. Oh, what a collision at the 38-yard line. Ted Hinton, that is some kind of hit.
When he runs motion, they just drop in the strong side zone, all drop back underneath. Now, Walker is underneath the deep coverage, and Hinton, number 84, gets a great hit. Now watch Hinton come flying into Walker right here. And just a tremendous hit. Hinton has played extremely well this evening for Cal State Fullerton.
First and 10, Walker hung onto the ball. That's Cage in motion, top of the screen. Good catch by Kenny Nash. Up at the 45-yard line, right in front of the San Jose State bench. Tom Phillips with an interception on the coverage, but that was just excellent concentration.
Nash is having a night. I wonder if he and Allen are roommates. They've hooked up pretty well this evening.
Five catches for Kenny Nash, one for a touchdown. That's a career for some guys.
We haven't seen much of number three, Malo, tonight.
He was active in the first quarter. Second down and two. Slot out to the right side. In the slot is Stephen Crawford. Late developing play. Pitch back to Walker. And a good defensive play that time by the defense for Fullerton State. Over in the center of things, number 57, Greg Williams, and Vern Norwood. He was the corner that turned the play inside.
Now that was the veer action again, and Cal State Fullerton just put great heat on. Blue people took away the first two options, the pitch outside, and Walker couldn't quite maintain his feet, and the corner did a good job of evading the block outside and successfully shut down the play.
And for Greg Williams, the linebacker, 57, he was redshirted last year. He dedicated himself over the summer, worked out on a weight program, and put on about 30 pounds. Third and two. Allen backpedals, looks, fires, got his man. First down, San Jose State, inside the 40 of Fullerton State. Todd Cage on the reception, Mark Collins on the coverage.
Now here's a fine job by Allen coming out away to his right, getting his shoulders turned up the field and throwing a perfect strike. Now watch him get his shoulders turned, gets that shoulder roll around, and throws a perfect strike to Cage. Very fine job by Doug Allen, and Cage is wide open.
And again, that's your left-handed quarterback rolling right and throwing against his body. Very difficult to do. First and 10, San Jose State, they trail by five. Allen. And complete and almost intercepted by Mike Romero. He has four career interceptions, three of them this year.
Here's a perfect example of a ball that shouldn't have been thrown. He gets in a three-step drop, sets, throws, and now the break on a ball by Romero looks like a touchdown. If it hadn't been tipped by the defensive lineman, probably would have been a touchdown. The ball should have been thrown to a secondary receiver. Should never have thrown the football.
Second down and 10. Clock stopped on the incompleted pass. 10:07 left to go. Fourth quarter. Allen got a safety valve man, instead got a man wide open, and that's Page. First and 10 for the Spartans inside the 20 of the Titans. Mike Romero and Tom Phillips, but that time Cage, he just found the seam, coach.
Cage ran a post route, and Walker was dragging underneath, held the coverage underneath, and there he's dropping right behind the DB and in front of the free safety, and he is just wide open in that hole in front of the safety. There you can see the free safety coming, Phillips. Big, big hole, and a good job by Walker holding the under coverage underneath.
First and 10. Motion across by Steve Johnson. Little delay. Walker gets up to about the 17-yard line. Sean Ford, the co-captain of the Titans, and Bill Bryan were there. Bryan, the freshman, number 88, 6'2", 220. You don't think they'll work him in the weight program?
I tell you, he's going to be an excellent one for a freshman. He's got all the frame, got great ability to hit you. He certainly looks like the start of a fine, fine linebacker.
An emotional Claude Gilbert over on the Spartan sideline.
Sure, Claude would like to see this one. This is one they need right here to get it in the end zone.
8:55 and counting left in the ball game. Titans lead by five, but the Spartans knocking on the door. Nash out wide to the right. In the slot to the left is Todd Cave. Here comes the reverse. Nowhere to run. Now he unloads, and it is incomplete and almost intercepted. And Lafu Manalulu looked a little bit like Gero Yepremian there. I don't want it. Who wants it?
Tell you, that's one of those plays that could have turned out extremely bad. About the only chance he had was really bust it and come back all the way outside. When he sets up, there still isn't anyone open. Now he's fighting for his life. Almost throws the pick.
And as you see, there were no blue jerseys near the football.
Yeah, the only chance he had to even not be called for intentionally grounding number five was upfield about 6 yards. Walker.
So it's third and seven for the Spartans. Field goal doesn't do much good. Fake draw. Allen fires. Incomplete, and a good defensive play. Walker was the intended receiver, but you see Greg Williams, number 57, who was right there.
Had some good man coverage on all the receivers upfield. Very good coverage by 57. Flying to the ball. Watch the break to the ball. Fine job. The ball been thrown out in front. Number five Walker may have had a chance.
So we'll see Tony Hunter, the field goal kicker. Tony Brown, the senior out of Victoria, British Columbia. 3 out of 4 in the field goal departments. Doug Allen, the quarterback, is the holder. It's on its way, and it is good. So the Spartans have drawn to within two. Fullerton State leads 20-18, 8:24 left. So we'll be back to Spartan Stadium after this timeout.
If you're looking for excitement, Anaheim Toyota Maserati has just what you're looking for. Come in and test drive the new Maserati Biturbo and compare its value against any other sports coupe on the road today. Boasting the driving force of a twin-turbocharged 185-horsepower engine, this Eurosport also features luxurious leather interior, air conditioning, a technically pure sound system, and more, all standard and all for just $24,999. Anaheim Toyota Maserati, Anaheim Boulevard, off the 5 freeway left at Cerritos. Come share the excitement.
Hi, I'm Ann Bloom with some information that may be news to you. Some people think stealing HBO and cable TV is not necessarily a crime. Well, it is. There's a law against cable theft, and it's no joke. If you get caught rigging your cable box or hooking into cable lines without paying, penalties can run as high as $6,000. And in some states, you can spend up to a year in jail. There's nothing funny about stealing pay TV, so don't do it.
Cable theft is a crime.
Tony Brown, who just banged through that field goal to draw the Spartans to within two, will spot it at the 40-yard line. 8:24 left to go in this football game, and it has been seesawing back and forth. Fullerton State with that two-point lead, that last field goal, 31 yards by Tony Brown. It could come down to a field goal by Tony Brown. Trailing by just 2 points, Spartans would like to get the ball back, and a field goal by Brown could give them a 21-20 victory. But of course, Gene Murphy of the Titans has got other ideas. He knows he's got to score one more time. Rick Calhoun is back deep, and he'll watch this one sail out of the end zone.
Think Brown's a little pumped up.
That was 60 yards in the air. In the passing department, a quarterback comparison, Carlson was 9 of 19, 101 yards and one interception when he left with his windpipe almost removed. And then Doug Allen came in. He's been 12 of 24, 129 yards and two touchdowns for San Jose State. Kevin Jan, on the other hand, 9 of 19, 149 yards and two touchdowns for Fullerton State. They've got the ball, the Titans do, and a two-point lead. Calhoun almost bobbles the exchange and bangs his way up to the 22. It brings up second down and 8. And Danny Clark, who was bothered by injuries last year, second team All-American out of Santa Ana, in there on the hit.
And here's the thing that Clark's looking for right now from the San Jose defense. This is a time when they must suck it up, must have a great defensive stand. On the other hand, Cal State Fullerton looking to run the clock out. Let's see if a blue shirt emerges as a leader.
Second down and 8, 7:45 left in the football game. Calhoun and Hood are your running backs. Jan looks at the blitz, unloads, incomplete at the 35. Pressure by Danny Clark. He came through on the blitz, and Kevin Jan was lucky, Coach, to get rid of that football.
Wasn't he? Danny, watch Danny now as he comes in. Very nearly got a clean swap on 74 and a direct line to the quarterback. Danny has made a difference. He's been very, there's no question that the pattern is open, but the great heat by Danny really doesn't make much difference whether it's open or not. No chance to throw the football.
You don't think Marcus McDade is respecting the speed of Corin Reddick. He's 7 yards off. They can come back to him anytime they want to. And I'm sure Reddick has told his quarterback. Jan sprints out to the left, comes back, looks over the middle, got a man wide open, and misfires at the 40. He looked for Reddick, and he really tried to force that. That one wasn't there.
You know, he has a tendency to pick a receiver and stay on him. I'm sure that's part of not having a great deal of experience at the quarterback spot. He picked Reddick out, and he was going to stay with him. And that's not a bad one to pick out because Reddick normally does get open. San Jose that time had very good pressure. Maybe Danny Clark, coming off that injury, will emerge as the man that they're looking to really put great zing in the San Jose defense.
Fourth and eight, Jim Sirwa will punt the ball. San Jose State, they've got the return on. High, high kick, hangs a beauty. K.C. Clark comes up and fields the fair catch at the 45. So the Spartans, with good field position, trail by two with 7:26 left to go.
We're not a company, but outstanding people come to us every day. People who want to make a contribution to a team and do work that really counts. People eager to see new places, do the unusual, and find the unusual. People who become your friends for life. People just like you. We're not a company. We're your country. We're the Navy, the Air Force, the Marines, the Army. We're the Armed Forces. It's a great place to start.
Now with Castrol, the motor oil engineered for smaller cars, you'll save more than wear and tear on your engine. You'll save on Prestone antifreeze, Simonized wax, STP gas treatment, Purolator filters, and more. In every 12-pack of Castrol, a rebate's worth $45. So Castrol makes things easy on your budget while it makes things easy on your engine. The Castrol money-back 12-pack.
It's been a good one. I'm Jim Kelly, Mouse Davis, alongside, and we hope you've enjoyed it here on ESPN, our Thursday night edition of college football. We've got lots more on Thursday night. Back to pass. Allen unloads, looks, got his man, Walker. Walker cracks across midfield and dives down into tight territory at the 47. James Howard, the man that bumped him out of bounds.
Good effort by Walker, making those extra 3 yards and also getting it out of bounds to stop that clock. Clock becomes a very important factor in the ball game now. 7:18 to go and 2-point lead. Excellent field position for the Blue Shirts.
Second down and two in the Blue Shirts of San Jose State, coached by Claude Gilbert. Line up with a back split. Walker and Crawford. Allen will keep it himself. Almost lost the football. In his desire, Miles, to get the extra yardage, he had that out there like a loaf of bread.
A great job by Brian filling that crease. He really flew to the ball, and Williams flew outside the other inside linebacker, number 57, and made the play on Allen. Very fine. Now watch this. Watch this. Right there, great shot on the dive. Now watch Williams come flying across from the inside, and a very fine pursuit by Fullerton.
Picks up the first down. Backs are split. Walker along with Meredith. Motion across. Steve Johnson, number 39. Allen Watson fires behind the intended receiver. Incomplete at the 33-yard line. Kenny Nash, a sprinter out of Anaheim, California, came to the program from Fullerton JC.
The motion really opened up Nash. When they ran the motion outside of Nash, there's a big hole inside, and Allen just threw the ball behind him. But certainly the play was well conceived. Wide open Nash. Ball thrown behind, second and 10.
You saw that sideline shot of the freshman, number 91, Wade Ashbrenner. That's been the story of the game. You need a MASH unit here tonight. Talk about intense hitting. Second and 10. Spartans trail by two. In motion, that's number 81, Todd Cade. Allen fakes the handoff, spins loose, gets free, breaks a tackle, and gets spun backwards again. by Sean Foy. You know, that, and you've been through it so many times, that's a scary situation. The runner is fighting for the extra yardage, and he's got the ball out there, and nine times out of ten, he's going to cough it up while he's fighting to try to go forward.
You know, and he made a great move that time, Allen, to beat Phillips on that first by that safety coming on his stunt inside, and then almost left the football on the ground. Fullerton is shutting down the veer much, much better at this point in the game.
Third and nine, would you blitz?
Third and nine? No, I would not blitz. They're off in maximum coverage. And a set, lay outside. Good job. Excellent play. Excellent defensive play. And that's the way Cal State Fullerton should have played the ball. They all dropped, let them have it underneath, and rallied to the football. Maximum coverage with a three-man rush. Very fine job by the defense. And now it's fourth down. Big play time. Suck it up time for San Jose. Suck it up time for Fullerton.
Andre Harris with the big play defensively for the Titans. Now, fourth and six, do you go for it or do you punt the ball away? 5:35 left.
You go for it. Pretty good field position. You got a chance of only making 21 yards or 50, less than 20 yards on a punt if you kick in the end zone.
Fourth and six, Allen bootlegs.
Give him
fires
the ball.
Incomplete at the 25-yard line looking for Todd Cage. Not really a catchable ball. It was thrown extremely hard, but in fairness to Doug Allen, he was feeling some heat from behind. He could hear him breathing.
Here, had some heat. Now Cage is going to drive up the field, now break it to the outside, and he had a crease, and he was open, and the ball's overthrown. Good job by Romero closing on the ball, and Cage would have been tested to see how much concentration he had had the ball been thrown on the money.
So the situation is this. 5:24 left to go. The Titans with a two-point lead. Really can't afford to sit on it because a field goal for San Jose State would win the football game. Let's see how Gene Murphy elects to play it. Mark Hood, Rick Calhoun are the running backs in the I-Pro set, and Kevin Jan has gone the whole way at quarterback. Calhoun makes a move inside. First down and look out. Calhoun almost breaks it. One man, Larry Weldon, saved the touchdown.
Fine job of running the football up inside. Just a lead back outside off a sprint draw action. It was by Calhoun. Calhoun made a very fine run on the play.
So it's first and 10, and that's a big first down. It also was a pickup of 20 yards. Out wide to the right side goes number 23. That is Alan Pitts. And deployed wide to the left side, number 18, the game breaker, Corn Reddick. Averages 19 yards per catch. You don't know any coaches like him in the pros, do you?
I think there's a chance a kid may have a future.
Guy in Denver likes to air it out
yes,
once in a
indeed.
While. First and 10. Calhoun gets the block, turns the corner. That's another first down. Larry Weldon, who has been all over Rick Calhoun. Otherwise, it's six. Watch 74, Mark Stevenson, the pulling guard.
Hey, now again, Stevenson's been doing this all night, done an excellent job. Gets a great block on the backer. Very fine job of cutting inside by Calhoun. And you don't mind a guy running out of bounds if you get a first down. You'd rather keep it rolling in this position. But Fullerton is doing an excellent job maintaining the line of scrimmage. Very fine job by Stevenson.
Backs are split. Bernes Scott gives Calhoun a rest. Hood is still there at fullback. Now they go to the I-Pro set. The tailback is Scott. He's got the ball. Behind the blockers, penalty flag is down. And if this is holding against Fullerton State, it'll bring up first and 20. And that could be the break that San Jose State needs to try to force some kind of a turnover.
Certainly a lot of time left in the ball game. Good job of just maintaining the feet. San Jose put very good heat on the ball packer and a lot of bodies flying to it. Can't stand the penalty in this situation if you're Cal State Fullerton. More importantly than maybe the lost yardage is you'd like to keep the clock spinning.
Flipping against the Titans. So it'll be first and long with 4:49 left to go, and the Titans leading by 2, 20-18. Yeah, we'll have to keep our eyes on number 18, Corn Reddick, who was so hot in the first half, but really hasn't been much of a factor here in the second.
Clipping, offense, 15-yard penalty, still first down.
I'll tell you what, our referee, Hazen McNitch, He's had as much airtime as you tonight.
He certainly has.
He's going to have to join after it before this one's done. You have to join the union. First and 25. Holding would have been better. They go up top. Reddick is open. Incomplete at the 22. And a penalty flag is down. And if it's against the defense, it's a first down.
They were giving Reddick a lot of attention out there, double covering him. He turned outside and then broke it up on top. The man stayed with him, and then the safety came over the top to double cover.
John King is listed as number 25 on the San Jose roster. And he was the man apparently called for pass interference. And that doesn't make the locals too happy. Was it pass interference, Coach?
Let's take a look at number 18 as he drives up. There's the out move. Now he drives up. 25 pushes him. Now he takes off again. The ball's there. 25 bangs him early. It's one of those you could go either way. I really think that it's a very marginal call in this situation. This is a nip and tuck, and maybe I didn't see the previous call. Might be another one of those a little bit get even time.
Defensive pass interference, automatic first down.
And the pros would have been an illegal chuck, but they don't have that rule. And he was just reacting to the football.
Tough.
Probably wasn't any more pass interference call than the one they didn't call earlier.
Tough call.
Yep.
They were both spinning backwards for the ball. Ball's up there. Everybody's got a right to it. First and 10.
Big break for Fullerton.
Huge break. They're looking at second and 25. Instead, they get a first and 10 at the 28, but nothing doing there. And Jim Hollinger, you know, he has emerged as the defensive leader.
Certainly on the last couple, three plays, he has that great pursuit to the football. That time he came home clean and made it. I tell you, between he and Danny Clark, those two young men may be the spark that they're looking for. Both of them, excellent movement to the football.
Second and 12. If you're Gene Murphy, do you throw the football? Wide to the left goes Corn Reddick. To the right side, top of your screen, Alan Pitts. Kevin Jan, the quarterback, with his backs. Burness and Hood split. This is Hood. Hood hammers down to the 25. It'll bring up third and long. Jimmy Priest on the tackle out of Stockton, California, MVP at junior college. Now in third and 8, Coach.
Kurt Lyon has had three or four plays where he's been there and hasn't quite made the play. Third and 8, we still would like the field goal. Now, if you get the field goal and you get a 4-yard gain, you're in good position for the field goal. I would still look for them to be a little conservative in this position.
Well, maybe a rollout, a high possession kind of pass. Reddick, wide to the left. He's the one to watch. Allen will keep it on the ground, and they give a reverse. Reddick needs a block. Gets to the outside. Oh! Casey Clark just stood him up and drove him backwards at the 25. Otherwise, Reddick breaks it.
I'll tell you, great athletic move by Reddick to get where he got. And here they run a reverse, which certainly was not the conservative movement. Now Reddick makes two or three excellent moves. There he loses one. Now he poops it back outside. And now there's a pop coming in from the sideline. And now Reddick gets a lick right here. Great hit by number 16, KC Clark.
Big field goal try. A 43-yarder by Len Strandley. And it's on its way, and it is no good. Wide to the left. 2:21 left to go, and the Spartans have dodged a bullet. 2:21 left to go in the game. It'll be San Jose's ball when we return. They're down by two.
Many stores, the person who sells rock albums also sells hardware. But at Century Hardware, the person who sells hardware, like McCulloch 16-inch gas chainsaws, $184. Werner 6-foot stepladders, $25.88. And Dennis Dorr says $3.88. So who would you rather buy from? Someone who knows hardware or someone who knows rock and roll? Century, where hardware isn't a sideline.
In my line of work, your insurance isn't on a piece of paper. It's up here, and it's in your equipment.
With all the technology that's built into today's cars, I just don't trust mine to anything but AC filters. An AC oil filter can help protect your gasoline engine for up to 15,000 miles. An AC air filter, up to 30,000 miles.
Never wait for trouble. Protect your car with AC filters.
Now get rebates on AC filters. Call 1-800-AC-DELCO for a participating dealer.
It is nail-biting time for both coaches. Claude Gilbert, San Jose, his team down by two. Gene Murphy looking for his first win of the season. Everybody will get double coverage here like Todd Cave and Kenny Nash. Doug Allen, the sophomore quarterback, in trouble, and he is sacked. He is sacked, and it is John Carlson back in. Carlson, who almost had his windpipe removed by Sean Foy, number 90 of Fullerton State, back in at quarterback, and the clock continues to move.
And once again, Hinton, number 84, linebacker for Fullerton, puts the heat on, makes another big play.
How about switching from Doug Allen, who's gone the entire second half, to certainly a rather cold Carlson?
Certainly. I think they have more confidence in Carlson and in the passing game. It's going to be a passing situation, but Allen has had an excellent contest.
Second and 21. He doesn't want to get it all back. Safety valves out and misfires. Now that is simply being rusty. Man was wide open. Carlson has to be bothered by the windpipe. He's had the ice pack on it for almost 2 hours.
Really threw up his back foot. He had Walker wide open underneath and merely overthrew the football.
Third.
Got a big, big play for San Jose.
Third and 21. Now, do you throw something, do you pick up 10 or 15 yards and go for it on fourth, or do you try to pick up all 21?
I think you got to throw a play that's in that 15, 16 yard range, but give yourself a chance for the big play. Still got to come off a read.
Carlson got his man. First down. Kenny Nash. He beat the All-American candidate Mark Collins.
Here's the play, and Nash is just going to run a post. They're dropping back in zone look. Collins is kind of cushioning. Phillips is getting hung up a little inside. There's a nice crease between Collins and Phillips. And an easy throw for Carlson.
1:20 left in the ball game. Carlson got his man. That is Cage. Out of bounds to stop the clock. No, they say the clock keeps moving. 1:10, 1:09, 1:08. The Spartans go into the hurry-up offense. Carlson at the controls. He's got Nash, 89. He's got Cage, 81. The clock winding inside a minute. Carlson with the audible. Backs are split. Meredith and Randy Walker. 53, 52, 51 and counting. They wasted 15 seconds. Incomplete. That'll stop the clock.
Now it's time to use the timeouts because we only got 48 seconds left. We lost a little on the clock there. Carlton is throwing the ball well.
If you're thinking field goal, Mouse, and of course they need a yard to keep possession of the ball, Tony Brown has kicked one this year 47 yards against Utah State, his career longest 48 yards against Long Beach State. So they've got to get another 20 yards to get him into range. Line of scrimmage, the 49 of the Titans of Fullerton State. It's third and one. Carlson will pass. Carlson wants it all. Fires downfield for Crawford, and it is dropped. Collins drops it and then kicks the end zone marker about as far as Tony Brown would have to kick a field goal.
I don't believe they'll go for the field goal here. Got to get the first down, keep the thing alive, come back. Very fine play by Collins. He had him covered all the way. I was surprised at the going for all the money on that. Maybe they thought they were going to catch him napping, but in this situation, you're not going to catch many teams napping.
All right, you commented on the call. How about testing the All-American candidate when you need to go up top for all of it? I think you want to work the other side. You don't go against their best cornerback, do you?
Unless you believe that he's so aggressive that he's going to be coming on the play action.
Fourth and one. Quarterback keeper over the left side behind David Diaz Infantani. First and 10 for the Spartans, but 39 seconds left to go on the clock. Line of scrimmage will be the 45-yard line of Fullerton State. And again, they've got to get now at least another 15, 16 yards to be even close to Tony Brown field goal range. But with one timeout left, only 39 seconds.
There's certainly plenty of time to get themselves in position.
Yep, you don't want to get greedy. You've got Kenny Nash, you've got Cage, and I think if they just work the ball a little sideline outs to either one, they're going to pick up some yardage.
What you like to do is get the first down, stop the clock with a first down, immediately get back to line scrimmage, stop the clock by throwing out of bounds. Now you got time, if you don't believe you're in field goal range, to get yourself another 10, 12 yards. And now you still got your timeout left.
This crowd has come alive. It's been a good one, and we hope you've stayed with us here on ESPN. If you snuck away to watch a little bit of the baseball, Mets and Cardinals, Royals and Kansas City, welcome back. 20-18, our score. The Titans lead, nursing that two-point lead, 39 seconds left. The man who's got to have some butterflies is Tony Brown over on the sideline.
He undoubtedly knows that he is going to come down to his attempt anyway.
First and 10. Spartans need about 18 yards. Cage in motion. Carlson, straight drop, pumps, in trouble, unloads, fires out of bounds. Good play.
Good decision to get rid of the thing. Good coverage by the entire defense. A lot of drop-off and pretty good heat with no more rush than they had. Carlson made a good decision to throw the ball out of bounds.
Carlson pressured by number 90, Sean Foy. They, of course, have met before. It was Foy with a right chop to the Adam's apple that knocked Carlson out of the game. Second down and 10. There's our situation. Just 34 ticks on the clock. Wide to the right. The slot formation, that's Cage in motion, top of your screen. Carlson fires. Intercepted and picked off by the Titans. And Fullerton State will win their first game of the year. Mike Romero, 3 interceptions this year, 4 for his career, will chalk up number 5 and chalk up a win for Gene Murphy of Fullerton State.
Excellent job by Romero, just sitting back, reading Carlson's eyes. The wide receiver curls inside, and now Romero sitting on top of it. Just the ball's thrown. Now watch Romero right at the top of the screen on the right side. Now he breaks to the football, and it's a pick all the way. Almost got it knocked out of his hands by Hinton, number 84, but this contest is now over, James.
You know what the book on Mike Romero is?
Here we get another
look. Excellent athlete who moves well, understands the defense, and anticipates. Well, he anticipates there, and he steps in front, and now we'll just run out the clock. Kevin Jan will fall on the football.
And that will be all of this one.
One more timeout for San Jose State. Let's recap the scoring for you. It all began with a safety when Corn Reddick was trapped in the end zone, giving San Jose State a 2-0 lead. Then the Titans came back, a 60-yard pass from Todd White, the halfback option to Corn Reddick, and it was 7-2, and a lead that the Titans would only relinquish one time. Reddick figured in the next score as well. A 35-yard scoring strike from Kevin Jan, the quarterback, to Corn Reddick. 14-2, Fullerton State was on top. And then Kenny Nash, after Fullerton State had an illegal substitution and a 5-yard penalty just before the end of the half, it gave San Jose State a second chance. Kenny Nash, an 11-yard touchdown toss from Allen. It was only a 5-point Spartan deficit at the intermission, 14-9, Fullerton State on top. It was Mike Meredith with a 4-yard pass from Allen, his second of the game, that gave San Jose State a short-lived 15-14 lead early in the third quarter. And then Wade Lockett on the receiving end of a Kevin Jan touchdown toss, 17 yards. The pass and the 2-point try for conversion failed. 20-15 was the score. And Tony Brown closed out the scoring with a 31-yard field goal to draw the Spartans to within 2. He never got a chance to try for the game winner after Mike Romero came up with that game-ending interception. Barring penalty, this will be the last snap. Kevin Jan will fall on it. The Spartans cannot stop the clock. So, Mouse, the first one of the year for Gene Murphy's Titans. I think they've found themselves a young squad. They'll band together with this win. And for the defense of Claude Gilbert, he was concerned. I think a leader has emerged, but he's still got some holes to fill.
Tough loss, certainly, for San Jose. Great win for Fullerton. Gives them an opportunity now to be undefeated in conference play. And San Jose played well. Their defense did come alive. And so that makes both of them happy to some degree. Fullerton, obviously, the happiest of the group.
Our thanks to our spotter, Billy Werndell, who motored in from Philadelphia. He'll follow us on down to Auburn. We've got Mississippi coming up against Auburn on Saturday night. And we've got more football news for you here on ESPN. Stay with us.
We're not a company.
But no company has more pride in what they do.
Or more pride in how well they do it.
We offer you a meaningful and fulfilling future.
One that goes far beyond the ordinary.
One that brings with it the respect and admiration of Americans everywhere.
We're not a